It's so stupid, it's positively brilliant.
The Brilliant Idiots Podcast.
Yep, Charlamagne the God.
Andrew Schulz.
We are the Brilliant Idiots. Back for another week of brilliant idiotness. Okay. Hezzy is here.
Yes, sir.
Wax is here.
Yo.
And we have two special guests from the We Talk Back podcast on the Black Effect iHeartRadio podcast network. Their podcast names are AJ and TamBam. I don't know them as such. Okay, but that's their podcast names. AJ and TamBam from South Carolina, that's from right. Columbia and Charleston, respectively.
Check.
Okay, the 803 hey. And the 843. What's happening? How are y'all?
Great.
How's New York treating you?
New York filthy.
Tell the
dirty,
truth. You don't like
man.
New York.
Dirty,
no, not at all. I can visit, but I can never fucking live here.
No, it's so dirty, man.
Yo, chill. This is my home, though.
No, Schulz, you can't defend New York from 400 miles away. All right.
You left New York for the same reasons.
Comfortable.
You left New York for the same reasons, okay? Knock it off.
He out there with his chest out and shit. Look.
Chest hands right.
out the other day. Come on,
yo, why girls are the only ones that put their chest out, man? I got nice titties too.
Where your Cuban at?
Look at this.
You need a cleavage, bro.
You said, where's my Cuban?
Yeah.
Got
no,
you.
No, next
hey! Cigars on ice.
No, that one.
Come on, baby. Hey. We ready out here.
Show them the AP. Show them the AP. You got the AP on the day,
this little thing. Oh, this little thing.
I must say, AJ and TamBam have corrupted young Taylor already.
Uh-oh.
Taylor, that's our job.
Taylor walks in the studio this morning and she's like,
fuck these
after
niggas.
Hanging out with AJ and TamBam and Mandy, I realized that I'm doing this men thing all wrong. I walked out.
I shut off. I clipped my ears off.
I walked out. Did I not walk out, Taylor? I walked out because I already know what the conversation was. What did y'all tell her at lunch yesterday?
She just needs to make sure that these men are making sure she feels special. That's all we tell her.
What do you mean?
Like, treat her nice and don't let them get away with anything.
They do treat her nice.
Nicer. Yeah. Financially nicer.
And if you got to get multiple to cheat, you know, combine them. You can do that too.
So
whoa.
I never knew that.
Penis a year.
Whoa.
You don't gotta smash everybody.
You're a liar. That's the lie she said. She said that later on. They don't be fucking everybody.
We don't.
That's true. But there's nobody that's just giving y'all money.
That's not true. Yes, they are.
I don't believe it.
Hold on.
You ain't gotta believe it.
Are you giving head?
What's happening? No.
Huh?
You guys aren't giving head to the guys?
No.
I have TMJ. I have a doctor's excuse why I can't give head.
What's TMJ? Too much jaw?
From dental work, not from sucking dick.
Really?
So your butt is meat off?
My shit be clicking and everything, right?
That means you're doing it right.
Oh, lock jaw like that? Yeah. You know, like a pit bull, lock jaw is like a hold on.
But my mouth does not ajar that much.
Yeah.
So it gets tired quick. So I give out the doctor's excuse.
You give that to guys and they accept it?
No, she lying.
That's my excuse, though. I can't do it.
I refuse to believe that men are just giving out money and not getting nothing in return.
Can I ask you
they
a question?
They are getting things can in return. It's just not sex. Fine.
What's the question?
I just have a question about TMJ because I've heard girls say this excuse before. Why is TMJ... not stop girls from talking so much. Like, they never have any problem opening their mouth to tell you stories
we
and shit.
We need to hand out some more TMJ.
Yeah, like, it's like TMJ is
TMJ
fine
for you too.
Up to here, right?
Can I buy and that then, shit?
Yeah. It seems like TMJ only affects the amount of, like, opening it takes for a penis to go in, right? Like,
no
yeah,
girl's
like, oh, I can't go out to a
time.
Fancy dinner, I got TMJ.
But you got your mouth open the whole time when you're talking too?
No. Mm-hmm.
Or when
no,
you're
you
eating?
You get
it's a different kind of open.
Now she's trying to keep her mouth closed while she's talking.
Y'all never tried to suck dick before?
Right.
Whoa. Whoa.
It's different.
Now, as I said before the podcast started, head is just head.
Now, if a guy wants to take you to a fancy restaurant, do you say, no, I have TMJ, it's hard for me to eat? Or can he take you out to a fancy restaurant?
Get the kids meal. You get the kids meal now.
You know you TMJ. Can eat with TMJ.
Some oatmeal.
Yeah, what the hell?
Like,
and why y'all act like eating
the
pussy
fork
is easy
much
too?
Smaller than a dick. Obviously,
I've never said that. If I was a guy, I probably wouldn't be eating pussy.
Yes, you get locked jaw when you down there too long.
Yes,
eating pussy is hard. It definitely is hard. There's it's hard. It's not built for eating.
Because it's just licking. It's just nonstop licking. Yeah. You know what's so crazy? I was having a discussion earlier with Wax, right? Because we were talking about like, like if people are sitting around discussing you giving head, that's just as like when guys do it with women. Don't you think it's just as disgusting?
That's the same thing.
If multiple women can say you ate them out?
That's a lot.
You don't think that's crazy?
So if a guy goes down on a bunch of women, you think he's gross?
He's a whore.
Yes.
You're a fucking whore.
Yes.
I'm going to still let you eat this pussy though, but.
You're nasty. Nasty guy.
Do those conversations happen amongst women?
Absolutely.
Yes.
Really?
Yes.
Group chat?
No.
That sucks.
Your ass.
But would you prefer a guy?
And I might pass the head to somebody else.
No, y'all don't talk like that. Come on.
Whoa,
stop.
Okay.
You know me.
Y'all pass the head along?
Yes.
What you
Why
mean?
Why you tapping my foot? We ain't talk about that.
Wait. Explain that. So if a guy is good at going down on you, you'll say, yo, you got to meet my friend AJ.
Right. Yes.
Oh, I thought you would keep it for yourself. Girls,
we've created like monsters, fellas.
I'm not selfish.
We've created monsters.
I can share with my friend.
Mm-hmm. Wow. What?
Yeah. If my friend, he's like a stress release and I know a guy.
That's crazy.
I don't know these people.
Me neither. What's going on?
Oh.
Chuck, you do not do that.
Why? You spanking me, nigga?
What are you doing,
Chuck?
No.
I charge for that.
Listen, we known AJ and TamBam. Do I got to call y'all that the whole time?
No.
Okay. I've known Ashley and Tammy for, I call Ashley Poopoo. We've known them for a long time. I've known Ashley for 20 years. Mm-hmm. I've known Tammy for about 18, I think.
Mm-hmm.
About 18 years. So we've known them for a long, long, long.
Ooh,
long,
so can long, I ask some Charlamagne questions?
Sure. Shoot.
Is it true that Charlamagne's penis is longer in the summer months?
What?
I don't know.
I would not know that.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah. What? You might know.
Jesus Christ, man. What the hell is wrong with you?
I'm just saying, maybe you pass them over to one of your friends or some shit. Who knows what happened down there in the Geechee streets of Charleston, South Carolina.
It's Charleston and Columbia.
It's Columbia.
The metro is different than Charleston. Right.
No, I never passed my friend.
The 803 is different than the 843.
Okay. Well,
it's a total different place. Anything else? You want to ask anything about Wax before we move on?
Oh, yes. I would like to ask something about Wax.
Okay.
He's always been a church guy. And he liked to pray.
Don't y'all be afraid. Y'all say whatever y'all feel like y'all need to say.
Wax is a church guy and he liked to pray.
Is it true that Wax has trouble achieving orgasms?
Why is all this sex stuff?
Well, because that's what's fun.
Hey, look.
This guy is so crazy. Tammy is the person who Chase waxed out the club.
Yeah.
For
many,
what?
Many, many years ago. Because Charlamagne, you called me.
Yo, bro, I listened to
that episode and you said that I was a bartender there. I was not. You called me and was like,
yo, bro, what is
going on? You up here with some bitches with some red dresses.
He's driving your ass.
I did not do that.
Yes,
I didn't ask you what she did. You told me no.
That
don't
sound like some shit this nigga, this dude will do.
What you mean?
You called me.
Come on now.
Yo, we pulled into the parking lot and I said, yo, she there? And he said, nah, she's not there. I said, I went in the bathroom. I came out, was a mob of fucking 6'7" fucking
girls.
Hand me
some towels, Taylor. Wait, you wasn't bartending at 360?
No, I was, but I wasn't there then.
Yes, you was.
I was not. You called me.
You were behind the bar.
No, I came up there with my friends because you called me up there.
Charlamagne.
I don't remember.
I know what Charlamagne, bro. I know he's lying through his teeth right now.
What? I can't confirm or deny. I don't remember this one. I thought you was working there at the time.
No.
He's sweating, bro?
Really?
He called me and he was like...
That's fucked up, bro. How you going
I don't remember this.
You even told me what the bitches had on. You was like, it's two bitches sweating, in red dresses. Wax with them. Come up here.
What? Hold on.
So picture me jumping over tables and fucking shit. That's what you want to see.
That's not how I recall. This is why stories are good, because everybody got a different story. I remember coming to 360.
No.
You was working there.
Mm-mm. Nope.
Not that night.
Nope.
Really?
Yo, no. You was so crazy.
No, you know what it was? Let me tell you what it was.
That's the type of shit you do.
What you mean?
Let me tell you what it was. Charlamagne was probably trying to set Wax up, and then he went in there and found out you weren't working. He was like, fuck. How can I get this girl here to create the drama that I need in my life?
That one.
So then he called you to come so that there could be a fight. Mm.
So was he in there talking to girls?
Y'all was with two girls.
No, I had nothing to do with it.
Look. Lying ass.
I don't recall any of that.
Yes, y'all was with two red girls. Two red girls.
Two red girls?
In red dresses?
In red dresses. Red bitches in red dresses.
That's not like them hoes.
What's a red girl?
And you told her I fucking bought the dress, bro.
No, and we ran them bitches out of there too.
Did you buy a dress?
No, I bought a fucking girl a dress.
No,
I don't remember none of
and
this.
He was like, come up here right now.
I can't believe this nigga.
I don't remember none of this.
Listen, Charlotte, we're unearthing our trauma from earlier parts of our life. And this is how we're gonna get through it.
That was definitely some trauma, man.
Yeah, you locked the door on me, yo. I ran to the truck and he locked the fucking door, bro.
Yeah.
Why did you want him to go through that?
What you mean? He deserved it.
Why?
Because I've been trying to get him to change his ways for a long time.
Oh, wow, man.
No, it's for real.
Oh, wow, 2016.
That was, no.
No,
no, I'm way. Saying he's saying since, oh. No, I'm saying he's oh, yeah? been straight since 2016.
That's a long time.
Yeah, it's a long time.
5 years faithful. By the way, I'm happily faithful. It's not. I'm not saying it like it's a problem. But mm-hmm. 5 years for a man?
That's
not
great.
To cheat? That's not a long time?
But what make you think women don't want to do that? Like, we have to have, like, a thousand time willpower.
Give me another towel, Taylor.
And that's good. That's
we
good.
Literally oh, get dick thrown at us on aisle 9 at Walmart. No.
Right.
Why do women say that? Y'all don't
because
really
because we
cheat.
Do.
Nobody really wants to cheat.
Yeah, but that's why it's
cheat.
Easy for you to cheat. Say no.
We might not want to cheat practice. With everybody, but we know who the fuck we want to cheat with.
Right. Whoa. Or we could.
What the fuck does that mean?
That sucks.
You know who you would fuck.
Who?
I don't.
I mean, you can tell.
Next up.
What is going on in this?
Oh, I don't
want to
hear
today.
This is terrible.
I don't want to hear trouble conversation. Don't you guys want to ask Schulz about?
No, I want to hear more about this because I love the way women think. Because
oh,
I'd be
I hate
wanting
this.
To know.
Oh God, this is I hate this. Go.
So, it sounds like trouble.
Even if you got a good man and the man is that, that's the love
women
of your
don't,
life.
Women just don't. I mean, you do have some women that just be out here, but for the most part, we need a reason. Men really? Just need a time and a place.
No, that's not true. No.
That is true.
Now, every time I've ever done it, it's been for ego purposes.
I thought you said
yeah,
you did it for them
the
because the girls
also.
Look lonely and you wanted to help them out.
That was me.
See? Now he just be telling on himself.
No, that was back in the day shit. Not me now.
I never knew
shit.
Wax was such a nice guy. Dan was like, oh, he's so charismatic. Like,
he used to be very charming.
No, I need more.
I love
tell
Wax
me more.
The Chuck?
I never understood why bitches was on Wax like that. We was in Anguilla and a random white bitch just followed this man into the middle of the ocean.
She thought he was going to drown.
With some blonde haired bimbo.
Nasty as hell. Having sex in the middle of the ocean.
No.
With somebody he just met.
But yeah. Where did this woman come
I
from?
I have no idea.
She was the lifeguard. Happens.
She was a mermaid.
I was drowning.
Stupid.
I really want to know though. So women have a guy in the tuck that they think about?
Oh my God! Don't tell me this. I
don't
want to
do
hear
like
this.
That, man.
No,
I ain't married
yeah,
yet.
They do. I'm learning. Wait, it's always but I'm like, learning to lie to like. I'm learning now to lie to men because I noticed that.
Lord.
I just you know if I'm too honest, yeah. That men hold that against you. So I now I'm learning. No, that's not what we do. We don't have a man in a cut.
No, that's not true. I would rather the honest
yeah,
conversation.
I want the honest person.
Yeah, I want the person
yeah.
to tell
yeah,
me.
Yeah,
it's
what always
it is.
One.
Yeah, you know
no.
who I'm next.
You stop
it's
doing that.
Always one.
You stop doing the bad behavior so that
you
can be honest. You can't be honest
that.
If you stop doing the bad thing.
And what I don't understand is why would you just give yourself to some dude who ain't invested no time
nothing.
In you, no energy, no nothing. He just get the fuck because you want to?
I'm how sad. You know that?
What you
how
mean?
You figure he not doing that? Yeah.
So y'all talking to them. So y'all cheating.
Y'all cheating soon.
Y'all
cheating.
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 Man, that next text back is a cheat.
I might be a little fraternizer a little bit.
Whoa.
I like to flirt a little bit.
Whoa.
And it it's gets like, me whoa. In trouble.
Yes.
I like to talk.
Don't you got a man?
Jesus Christ.
Yeah. Sometimes. I'm single, though.
It's the same shit. You know what it is. It's like you be in and then you out. And then you in and then you out.
I saw you leave a comment on Duval post this morning. And you say, can I be single in a relationship?
Yeah, because nowadays I'm leaning more towards being in a non-monogamous relationship.
Really?
What's that?
It's just hard being open. in a monogamous relationship, because I feel like a lot of people are in fake-ass monogamous relationships.
What that mean?
Everybody cheating.
Exactly. And people like the lie better.
Women cheat better.
People like the lie better. Cats cover their shit up. Dogs leave shit out for you to see.
Bro, we
that's just the
period.
Truth.
We in a like it's like we in a bizarro world.
We're all
like,
in reality, bro.
Hey, we're in no, alternate because now reality.
We're finally adjusting to what we've been going through with men.
With y'all, yeah.
No, but
we
are don't cheat.
We are not our what? Grandmothers. We work. We make money, so I don't have to sit at the house and man, wait for you
hey,
while
baby,
you
I know you
at your other family
shit.
House. I don't have to do that.
No way.
That's a triggering subject when people say that's not my grandmother, because one of my grandmothers allegedly got kids from my daddy's best my granddaddy's best
you
friend.
You find that shit out too?
Yeah.
You know, it's funny, especially in the country. Yeah, I found out so many things. I said, that's my cousin?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's my cousin because
double cousin.
Yeah, double
cousin. Brother.
I do feel like we're in an alternate reality though, because I am a faithful black male.
Me too.
Andrew's a faithful black male. Wax is a faithful black male.
Yeah, but how long did the women in y'all lives have to wait for y'all to get to that point? Like, right. I'm in that
I've
position
been chilling.
Too. I had to wait for the man to get to that point. Now I'm
tired. You
gotta
build him up. You gotta build him up a little bit.
But who builds me up?
Right. That
the
part.
Fuck?
If that guy's supposed to build you up
you
too.
You lose your mind in the midst of building someone else
nah,
up.
Nah, you got the right yo, partner. God. Believe me, it's easy. It's easy.
God.
See, that's the thing. Okay, God builds and especially you. In the black community, they push God to black women. No, like, y'all just
that's
go through
true.
All that shit.
We
that's
all
true.
Believe in God.
No. No, yes. But they push, like, you know, just... So I'm supposed to just have Jesus in my life, but you get all the bitches.
Y'all all the virgin, I just get Jesus.
You got to find somebody. You got to find somebody that y'all both on the same page. Believe me. You'll get it. Don't worry about it. I promise.
I thought you did.
She told me. That's why I'm surprised.
So you're just out here a whole cheating human
Let
being?
Let me see your
no,
hand.
I'm doing
no,
nothing.
She don't cheat.
Let me see
I'm
your
with
ring
myself.
Fingers. Let me see your
it's
ring
turned
fingers.
Around.
A ring I purchased.
Oh, that's what? Cute.
Yeah. I'm with myself at the moment. So Jesus things can change, though.
So wait a minute, the engagement's off?
I don't want to talk about that.
Okay.
She don't want to talk about that.
Good for him.
Jesus Christ.
Because my engagement's in a relationship, she don't talk about
good that. Good for him. We don't got to endure this. This poor, sweet man getting cheated on left and right. You got other guys just hanging around, eating your pussy, passing them off to your friends. This is terrifying.
Whoa.
I'm absolutely terrified.
I'm going to be honest with you. This ain't no way for y'all to live, man. Y'all sound like men.
Yeah, don't do that.
Don't be savages. Like men.
Sometimes I am a grown-ass man.
Y'all sound like early 2000s, late 90s men.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Stop. You sound like that.
Yeah, Matt Cologne, yo.
No, because at this point, I just rather just chill with myself for a little while. Mm-hmm. I have been in relationships Vibrators. For a long time. You know.
Yeah.
Like, I'm tired of being in a relationship.
No, I'm ready for a serious relationship. I don't sound like a man. And I do have men giving me money for nothing.
No, they're not giving it to you for nothing. They're giving it to you in hope of. That's what they're giving it to you. They
but that's what
you.
You're supposed to. You let a man wait. That's the importance of letting a man wait before you have sex with him. Because they'll either say or do something that's going to talk themselves out the pussy in the first place.
Mm-hmm.
Or they'll, you know, money speeds things up.
Really?
Yeah.
But don't the more you
nice things speeds things up.
But don't the more you buy a woman stuff, the more you give a woman money, now you accept expecting something?
Yeah you got to cash that in. You're just Bitcoin.
What Bitcoin? No.
Yeah, you don't
y'all
think
wouldn't
that
talk
he gonna
to
want
y'all
something
like that?
From
right.
You
know that's some bullshit,
right?
No, he's cashing that in eventually.
No, I would. I would talk to them like that. I would talk to them. I would, because you have to be straight up honest with your children nowadays, because life is coming at them fast.
Yeah, like would you tell your dad, like, listen, just because a man takes you out on a nice dinner date, that does not mean you should have sex with him.
Oh, no,
you
I
have
agree.
To have sex with
of course,
him.
Not.
I agree, but it is an expectation.
But men expect sex after dinner when we eat. Shit, we was eating real good the other night. Like,
yeah, I mean, that's what men gonna expect. Anything they
but
do,
that
they
don't mean they
door.
Gonna get it though.
If they, a man open your door, he gonna want it.
No,
you know what I'm saying,
open the door. Come on now.
But that's what
man,
I would
get out here giving back a miles away.
What
for pussy?
What?
Get a girl black and mild, you get pussy.
Where at?
Everywhere.
Who want black
first
and mild?
First of all,
pussy?
There ain't no quality pussy.
Right.
Black and mild,
disgusting.
So that pussy smoked out.
If that's the trade off, I don't want none of that pussy.
Black and mild at McDonald's.
But I would tell my daughters that yo, a guy would be expecting something. You know what I'm saying? Like
all
he ain't
guys
doing
are
this
expecting
to you.
Something
but we, that's why we need to stop teaching girls and we need to start teaching men how to treat girls. We're special.
So how should we treat
the boys how to act?
What's the best way to treat
women?
You?
Women are special.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
we know you're special.
So we
that's
teach
why
little
you get
girls.
Shit.
We teach little girls. Oh, keep your legs closed. Whatever. Yes. We shun the sexuality. Like women, we're sexual beings too.
Nope.
And
nope.
Then the men can just you're a man based on how many people you can run through. And then you grow up and you feel like fucking for black and miles and shit. You feel like then you grow up and now you feel like
I was wrong. I was a piece of shit.
Word is born.
You
feel like
okay, so you ran your whole life you've been running through bitches and then you expect to get a woman that's not ran through.
Right. I was running. I was getting pulled.
Calling women bitches.
Stop. We don't do that here.
I can't believe y'all.
How you know that?
We can call women bitches.
It's a term of endearment.
Who calls women bitches?
I'll be honest with you. I do call women bitches from time to time. I do say that. That is something I do still say, and I'm
adjectives
old.
That mattered. Like, don't say stupid bitch.
I'm not going to say stupid bitch unless that stupid bitch is acting like a stupid bitch, and then I'll call her that. But outside of that, I would never really say it. To be honest with you,
adjectives matter.
This is like really eye opening.
What do you
mean? Because I didn't know that women really thought like this in 2021.
Yeah, it's heartbreaking.
We aren't city girls though.
No, we're not.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, y'all country girls, but it's the same thing. The city girls ain't city girls.
First of all,
they country as hell.
It's southern.
Southern,
right?
Country is a state of mind. Right. I'm southern.
What's the
I'm
difference?
Not country. Country, you think about like you know country, Monk's Corner. That's the country.
Yeah.
I'm southern.
Yeah, right. Southern. I'm from the
south. Just because you're further down on the map does not make you any more or any less country. Because there's a lot of country people walking around New York.
Yeah, country girls can't cook.
Oh,
Southern girls cook.
Oh, by the way,
country girls can cook too.
New York is the most country people.
Yes.
Like I don't know why New York act like they not country as hell. Go
and
back
they
and
all
look
top
at
everything.
Go look at they match everything. You know what I'm saying? They cars, they Timberlands, they wear odd color schemes. They eat more country than so-called country folk.
Yes.
Like you clowning Soulja Boy, go watch some old Dipset videos.
Ooh.
Right. You know what I'm saying? Like what are you talking about? But you said something earlier Ashley, you said that men, we quantified our manhood by the number of women we slept with. That's not true.
That's what y'all are taught. You got Lil Boosie like taking his son to have sex with a grown woman.
He ain't gonna forget about that anyway. I don't remember a lot of y'all
suffer from abuse. A lot of men suffer from the abuse at the hands of women, first of all. So I'll be the first to say that
I was being abused for years.
Me too.
Yeah, and y'all think it's okay because, you know, you just got this grown woman. But then it kind of correlates into how you then treat women
when
you get older.
8 years old, I was getting head and sucking titties from a 20-something-year-old woman.
Yeah, that's
my cousin's ex-wife.
She molested you.
Yes.
I mean, yeah, I know that now.
Yeah, I know it now.
But in the moment,
most of the men I know have been molested by grown women.
What'd you say, Schultz?
I said in the moment, you just thought you were sucking them thangs.
Yeah, you thought you was a man. I did that too.
Yeah, and then when you're sitting around talking to all your homies that's around the same age and all of y'all talking about the same experiences, you're like, damn, all of us was getting molested at that age?
Same
so who ain't
too.
Shit, women or men?
Both.
Because that's fucked
the ones
up.
Who touching kids ain't shit.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
They should have their own name.
They do.
And it's crazy because it gave me so much confidence young, and then she took all the confidence away from me because when I made her stop, she started telling me I had a big ass nose. See what I'm saying? Why is it funny when men get abused?
It's not funny.
I thought about this.
It's not funny, Charlotte.
No, Charlotte, I thought about this, and she actually has a point because you've told this story before, and I've thought about this, and you said, I told her to stop because the smell of her dairy curl grossed me out. So she was like, you probably smelling it so well because of your big ass nose. Like, she was just coming back to you, right?
So imagine that women with her head going
she
up and down.
She thought
that
y'all were just dissing each other and it was an appropriate diss back.
Well, hey, yo, boy, dissing the fuck out of me. I got something for his ass.
Yeah.
And my goddamn grandma putting Neosporin on my nose thinking my shit's swollen.
That's real trauma, man.
She used to tell my grandma, look how big his nose is. His nose so big. Grandma coming with all kind of cream, putting that shit on my fucking nose.
It just made it shinier.
That's fucked up.
That's probably why my shit always shining now.
Yeah.
Lord have mercy, man. Listen. I want better for y'all.
Please.
What you mean?
I want y'all to find a man and settle the fuck down.
We be trying.
Yeah.
What you mean?
No, you're not.
I have a very high tolerance for bullshit.
Really?
Very high tolerance for bullshit.
What do y'all call bullshit, though? Because I think that we have a definition
of... Well, bitches. That's like the number one. Lying.
Not being accountable.
Talking to you crazy.
Yeah,
like
all of that stuff.
A lot of men, y'all are some bipolar ass people.
What's holding, not holding ourselves accountable? What's that?
Like y'all will do shit and then deflect everything onto the woman. Like, oh, I did this because you did this. It's always something that the woman did wrong, as far as I'm concerned.
Mm.
Now you gotta find a guy who owned up to his shit.
Yeah, but even when you own up, that doesn't mean I have to accept it.
Yeah, you guys never want to own up to anything you do.
I hate saying sorry, so I try not to do things I have to say sorry for.
So sometimes
you can always try that. I don't mind saying sorry if I'm wrong.
Nah.
I'm just never that wrong that much.
I always get this apology.
Or if I suck your dick, that's sorry. Like,
no, it's not. Sucking your dick is not sorry. Sucking your dick is how we get over the problem. But
acknowledging
what you did wrong. Yeah, you can hear it while you're doing it.
That'll help out.
Then you still be mad. You might nut, fall asleep, then wake up mad again.
Nah, you can't let him nut. If he don't nut, then he'll like you until you make him nut. If he nut, then he's still mad at you.
Yeah, that confuses me. So if we arguing, right, and then we have sex, I feel like, shit, everything good. Even if he was the one that caused the problem, I'm good the next day. Why are you still feeling like some type of way?
Keep him horny. He'll keep on looking at you as like being appetizing.
Yeah, but then I have to then be happy to have sex.
I want to know what the no monogamous relationship looks like. I'm intrigued by that. You know what I'm saying? I listened to the episode y'all had, the Cheaters Never Win, Winners Never Cheat, where y'all interviewed all the men that live double lives.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Do you think that could work for you?
It wouldn't be a double life because he'd be telling the truth.
Because you're being honest.
Exactly. And then you give the woman a choice, right, what she wants to expose herself to. Don't put my life in your hands.
Yeah,
you're right.
That's all it's about.
Right.
So if the guy's
open
being honest.
Open dialogue for the most part. Just being open to talk about whatever the fuck it is.
So what does that look like? Do I just get to bring any girl home I want to? Do I got to tell you?
Bring no bitches in the house.
No.
Keep them
home.
Dogs outside.
But it depends on the type of relationship too. Because some women might want another woman in the home with y'all sometimes.
Really?
Yeah.
An au pair.
Man, shut up, man.
What?
I don't know.
How do you even know that word?
I was looking for something. I need my clothes washed.
That's like the nanny. Au pair is like a nanny. Well, yeah, it's like a nanny, right? Yeah. But she actually lives there full time.
Yeah.
I don't want that. So you fine with that? If I'm trying to figure out how that would work if I'm a guy.
But you wouldn't want your woman to have someone on the outside.
Hell no.
No,
fuck no. That is disgusting. No.
Wow. There's nothing like.
Oh wow!
But you can have someone
coming home with your beard smelling like pussy. Right. That's just disgusting.
You don't do that either.
Beard glazed up.
Who does that?
So when y'all were cheating, y'all weren't eating other people's pussy. That's what you want to lie about.
No.
Oh, okay.
No. Get some head with your eyes closed.
You know how many times somebody else man I eat my pussy? Right. I sent his ass home with that face glazed up.
He was giving you money too.
Right.
Send his ass home.
Can I wash my face first? No. Teach you a lesson for your bitch.
What? That's a real story?
Listen, me and Chuck came with a night school together, boy. Jesus.
Hold up, man. Night school?
No, we not night school. We went to...
Benedict.
We had a class together.
Benedict was kind of like night school.
Don't do that.
It was summer school. We went to summer school together.
I didn't never go to summer school.
No?
No.
No, it was just regular college.
It was regular class.
All of y'all went to Benedict?
All of us.
I thought you went to Allen.
No,
you all went there.
No, Wax started at Allen.
He started at Allen.
Yeah. Tammy was at Benedict. You did college radio at Benedict.
I did.
No. Yeah,
it was at USC.
Yeah.
This dude almost got me beat up one time.
What happened?
What did I
do? You know what I'm talking about.
What happened?
Oh, yeah. The butt story.
It's the butt story.
Why you do him like that?
What happened?
Yeah, you gotta watch yourself.
So I was fucking with this dude, right? And I didn't even want my roommates to know I was fucking with this guy. I enjoyed fucking him. I liked fucking him.
Something else? This ain't what I'm thinking about? Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, I liked fucking him. And I'm like, damn. Wax, I'm on the side street. What? Oak Street, I think. Wax was like, yo, Chuckhead.
Chuckhead, what up?
He was fucking with so-and-so. I'm like, what? He told you that? I'm embarrassed. Like, why would you tell my friend that?
Yeah, she fucked up.
So I was like, damn, did he tell you I fucked him?
Meaning you put
this
something in
this dude takes it to the damn football locker room, both of them play football at school.
Because not only tippy toes, you can't come in the shower, because then he can't come in the shower no more either.
Tippy toes? It was tippy toes?
It wasn't tippy toes.
No, you got to see Andrew eating whatever he eating, enjoying this shit. Eating this shit like popcorn.
Shout out to Jack Your Meat, bro. Great turkey from my boy LaRon. Keep going.
So hold on. So you put something in the guy's butt?
No, just some fingers.
Oh, Lord Jesus.
And then what happened when you told the dude? He lied?
Like, he wanted to come to my apartment to fight me.
I didn't know that, but I took care of that, too.
Like, why would you want to fight me over the truth?
Whoa.
I didn't lie on you.
Yeah.
You should have just not told people we was fucking around. And that's why I do that, too.
I shouldn't have did
that. That's actually why I do that.
For
especially
insurance?
When I was younger.
Yeah, for insurance. That's good.
Yes. You make sure you tell the full story, sir.
Ooh.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But he came back, right? Yes. Eventually, he was like, I miss you, damn, yes. I miss you. He wanted his butthole finger.
Yeah, you hit that goddamn G-spot.
Yeah, like, he couldn't ask his current bitch to do it, so he was like, damn.
Yeah, man, that was so crazy, because I stood on top of the bench in the locker room like, yo, this nigga be getting his ass fucked up. He's like, yo, watch, chill out. I'm like, hell no, she told me that shit. Tell the truth, nigga. So that's why he had to fight. I get it.
Yeah, he couldn't, he couldn't fight Wax, but he's like, I gotta go fight somebody.
Yeah, I'm gonna go fight this girl. Like, no.
He wasn't fighting me, buddy.
And you actually loved me in the end. You don't want to fight me.
You hit him up again.
You were like a bully in college, though. You know, Wax used to get Reese's cups.
Wax is not a bully.
And stick laxatives in it and then pass them around campus to people.
I seen all that stupid shit.
I was
Reese's Pieces? I ain't never heard of Reese's Pieces.
Who the hell eating Reese's out your hand?
No, he would take the wrapper off, stick it back in, put the wrapper back on top. You know, the little mini cups. And pass them out.
Jesus. That was different. I wasn't a bully. I just handled whatever needed to be handled. It was my school. It's me. It's Wax.
They have people shitting up all over campus.
Like, wow, I used to get so by stupid, with everything, man. But I had to because I didn't know how to do nothing. You want me to go to class? I'm not going to listen to nothing.
I remember when Wax graduated. First of all, nobody could believe he actually graduated. And literally, it was mad girls.
I didn't, and this dude did.
You did.
Didn't graduate, yeah.
It was mad girls in the stands screaming mad different names. When Wax, they was like, they didn't call Herman's name. They didn't call Logan's name. I'm sitting there like, this motherfucker. Yeah,
and I skated up out of there. Yo, let's go. Be out.
Listen, you talked about how hoeing doesn't heal.
Oh, yeah. We got in trouble for that yesterday.
Why?
In the hot seat, the hot topic.
With the girls from Horrible Decisions.
Oh, Weezy and Mandy?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Because the podcast is called Horrible Decisions. They believe in hoeing.
Right. Yeah, but I feel like the general consensus at the end of the day was that it doesn't. If you're going through some shit, like just having a lot of different people, energies all on you,
right?
That's not going to solve anything. You're going to still be fucked up. Like somebody just come through, smash you and leave, like you're going to be curled up.
That's all that's
going to
happen.
Unless the healing that you need is sexual healing.
Right.
You know?
That'll be the only time.
Is there such thing as sexual healing though?
Of course.
Yes, absolutely.
Really?
Yes. After an argument.
So hoeing does heal then?
That's not hoeing, though. Like, I mean, that just could just be sex.
Yeah.
Hoeing, I'm talking about, like, I don't know.
More than one penis a year.
Yes, just running through.
More than one penis a year.
Not a year?
A year.
More than one penis a year.
Boy, shut up.
What the fuck? Why is that something? What's wrong with y'all?
Shut up.
How many penises you need a year?
It depends.
Well, I've only had the same penis for a lot of years.
Is it a hot girl summer or not?
No.
I think COVID is the best gauge.
More than one a week.
How many penises?
In the same zip code.
How many penises did you have during the pandemic? That's the best gauge.
One.
That's
one
all you need.
That's all you need. The fuck?
That's not a hot girl summer. What's a hot girl summer?
We ain't hot summer girls.
Warm girl summer. In 10 years, how many penises in 10 years? From 20 to 30.
It just depends. If you're in a relationship, then it'll be that one. But if you're not, it can be as many as you want.
Let's think about numbers.
When I'm single,
Let's think about numbers. In 10 years,
we ain't about to calculate my bodies now.
No, not yours.
You,
not yours. I'm saying one a year for 10 years is 10 penises. Two in 10 years a year is fucking 20. You don't want no more. Come on, let's think. Let's think about this.
What?
I don't get that math.
Do the dick math again. What was that now?
In 10 years, one a year.
Okay.
10. That's 10 penises. Right?
10 penises.
10 meats, right?
10 penises.
And if you have two a year for 10 penises. Years, that's 20 already.
I like experience.
Man, that's too much.
Why you want somebody? Man.
I mean,
you know, y'all be wanting virgin hoes. Y'all want a bitch to suck y'all dick on a handstand,
but never did it with anybody.
Exactly,
else.
It's impossible.
I don't think a man should demand anything of a woman that he don't have himself. Like, you can't say you want a girl to have a body count less than 20 if yours is well over 20.
I disagree.
No. So hold on. So if you smoking crack, you don't want your son not to smoke crack?
What?
That's your son.
How is that comparable?
What you mean it is?
No.
Just know y'all are hoes.
You want your girl to have less bodies than you. That's okay.
For sure. That's what I'm trying to tell Charlotte.
No guy wants that girl to have as many bodies.
I mean, listen, experience is experience. I don't care. Like, if you love somebody, you love somebody. You know what I'm saying?
If you love that car, if it got 400,000 miles on it, you're going to still buy it?
You just renovated.
You know what I'm saying? Half the whole engine, you're going to run it. The doors and everything.
Half the time, you won't know. You won't know how many miles are on that.
I try to tell you.
You won't know.
You try to gauge.
And if you're somebody like me who tries to be honest, like men look at you crazy.
You need somebody honest. No, I'd rather somebody honest.
How many you got?
You can't tell the truth about
that. You got some women, like, you think this is some nice, wholesome girl because she told you she only fucked 5 guys in life and she's 35 or whatever. And then here I am, like, shit, I lived.
That's right.
I had a whole phase in my
20s. That's right.
So that now I'm not, because I think the worst though was a 30-year-old.
Yeah, she did all them young boys.
Explain.
I know some women who, you know, got married, had children young, and now I'm divorced probably.
Mm-hmm. And they out here.
And 30, out here. And now you out here.
Out
like,
here.
You look stupid.
Why? Yeah. Why do you feel like they look
stupid? That's like the drug dealers. That's like the drug dealers right now.
We all got opposing views.
No, I'm just saying, why do they look stupid to you?
I mean.
Definitely stupid.
It's just.
Why though? Why is that stupid?
Let Chuck say it, because I'm a man.
I just feel like it's other things you should be concerned, especially if you got children. It's other things you should be concerned about. And they still looking for love.
Like
you running through all these people looking for somebody to love you.
Still trying to find a man.
Point.
That's what it is.
There's no woman in their 30s. If you had a whole phase in your 20s, a lot of us are not proud of proud of the whole phase, but it was necessary.
You can't unfuck people, so ain't no need to feel bad about it.
Yeah.
I don't have any regrets. And I just always tell young girls, like when I talk to young women, I feel like our podcast, my target market would be for younger women.
Mm-hmm.
So that we can tell them, like, listen, you don't have to go through this shit. We're telling you. Then that way you can live through us vicariously. Amen. You don't have to necessarily.
But if you
want to
have your
yourself.
Whole phase in your 30s, that's your prerogative. As long as you're doing it responsibly.
And keep your aggress to
say that that's stupid.
Stupid. No, how?
I don't think it's 30.
Yeah. Is not smart.
I don't think it's stupid.
Wax on a virgin hoe.
No, I'm on a virgin.
What's wrong with that?
I want somebody to be really truthful, but I just don't want somebody with a lot of miles.
I don't want no virgin. You don't want no virgin. Nobody wants a virgin.
Want somebody with
a virgin hoe.
But how is she possible?
What is a virgin hoe?
How does she know how to... Yeah.
Well, y'all want a faithful millionaire.
That's a virgin hoe in your eyes.
There you go, Schultz. Keep going, Schultz.
I'm just saying, we both asking for unrealistic things.
That is not true. That is not true, bro.
What?
I'm faithful as fuck.
You can get a little one with diabetes. Two dick don't work.
Lord have mercy.
You could get a faithful millionaire. That's not
exactly. Being faithful is not hard at all. Being faithful is simply a choice.
It is.
That's it.
Cheating is a choice.
Eating?
This guy over
cheating.
Here, bro. This guy,
cheating is a choice. Also,
when did Charlamagne become
choice, man. It's about
Captain
respect.
Fidelity, bro? This guy just started
October,
being faithful 2 days
October
ago.
October 2016.
Listen,
he
on
some Derek Jackson
did,
shit in it.
Yeah, right. The day he did.
Talk, son.
Don't let them call you Derek Jackson.
Hey,
everybody in this room know I'm clean. Wax know I'm clean.
Man, this nigga used to do me dirty. The day he got clean, boy, I was the piece of shit. Of
yeah, they sound like
day.
They were on heroin.
Remember that time in Vegas?
Ass crack.
Remember that time I got caught with that girl in Vegas?
Oh my God.
And the cops came to the room?
Oh my God.
This motherfucker mad as hell. I'm like, nigga, I've always been doing this shit. Now you fucking got mad.
No, because this shit was stupid. No, that was stupid. That situation was stupid.
The girl
as hell.
Chased me to my room. What the fuck am I supposed to do?
That's what he said. That was
the
his story.
The cops told us that.
What happened?
And the girl was with another guy.
I know.
A white guy. He walking through the hotel.
Looking like a big guy.
Exactly. The girl mad at the dude. And so somehow or another, she attaches the wax. Wax takes the girl to the room, makes her take a bath.
I was running down. Every time I turned the hole, I ran a little bit.
And so how she end up in your room naked in the tub?
Washed.
I don't know what happened after that.
See what I'm saying? Come on, man. What?
Straight pussy hole and washed it.
Well, the guards came to the door and was like, we watched her go through the room. They watched her fucking chasing me and everything.
I wake up with 10 phone calls. They like, yo, Wax, police, women. I'm like, what the hell is going on, man?
I called you and sent the police at my door.
I
thought it was for weed. Man. I'm like, I got you, man. Like, no, you kidnapped the girl. I'm like, whoa. What the fuck are you talking about? Kidnapped.
You know how bad that could have ended up?
Right.
Yeah, that could have been really bad, bro.
It
could have been.
As a man, when you start getting to that point, everybody got to grow up.
Yeah, we could grow up.
That's all I'm saying. That's just too much.
It was too much.
That's it. But I've been clean. I'm not no Derek Jackson ass nigga. I wouldn't even say it if I was bullshit.
He's sickening. I don't even listen to my own man like that. I'll be damned if I listen to somebody else's man.
I don't understand why women would even follow that guy.
Right.
The fuck?
I know you're faithful.
Men cannot tell me.
I know you're faithful. I know you're 100% faithful. But like, you act about your faithfulness the same way vegans act about their diet.
No, I don't. I act the way heroin addicts and crack addicts act about being sober and alcoholics. That's how I act.
Don't even go around that shit.
5 years. I'm getting the coins this year. Watch. This year, I'm getting the coins for brothers who have more than 4 years of chips? Not cheating.
Whoa, whoa. Why 4 years? You can say 2 years. That's hard.
No, pussy
is like a drug.
Yes, yeah,
it's worse than drugs.
It's new pussy, right?
Yeah. No,
it's new.
Just pussy, period. It's not new.
Let your girl not give you no pussy. You're going to be a fucking fiend out there.
You go crazy out there. You'll go crazy.
All that fucking porn. Mm. Stupid.
You go crazy. People have full knockdown, drag out arguments about that shit because men egos is fragile, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So if all women is, let's just say she tired and she don't feel like having sex, we automatically internalize that and think it's us. Like, damn, it's me.
Or she fucking somebody else.
Right. No, I don't go that far.
Yeah, men stupid.
No, I don't go that far.
Like, women physically just can't have sex all the time.
Just because you want it.
Yeah, really? Because your body.
Then why is she always smashing all these fucking girls? I mean, these guys then.
How do prostitutes
all
do
these
it?
Fucking...
Your girl, cocaine? We smashing a bunch of guys?
Who's smashing a bunch of guys?
No, cocaine.
It's up in the pocket.
A lot of girls who smashing a lot of guys will be on cocaine. It numbs them up.
I'm confused about this.
What?
Wait, what's going on?
You said, why do girls smash a lot of guys?
Yeah, she said that the girls don't like to smash all the time. They be having multiple guys a week and multiple guys a month, and it's kind of crazy.
No, when you got in-house dick, y'all having sex a lot, and then it slows up, right?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you're not smashing... I don't know. I've never just smashed all these people in 1 week. So
right,
I don't know.
Multiple guys a week. Who are you talking about?
I don't know why I don't feel like it hurts so much, though.
Girls.
Because you don't have a vagina. What do you mean?
What the fuck?
What you mean?
What the hell?
That don't hurt your feelings when your woman says, I don't feel like it?
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
But the girl told me it hurt worse than the guy. The guy said it probably hurt worse, though.
Bro,
I mean...
The other day...
The guys ain't used to turn the girls down.
The other day, I was like, we were initiating some stuff, me and my girl, and like...
What do you mean initiating?
Yeah, like we start, we're like starting to have sex, but not like...
Oh, making out.
Okay, gotcha.
Yeah, we're just like making out, getting intimate. This shit crushed me, bro. I pulled her close, and I kind of like grabbed her back, like, you know, when you're trying to get really sensual. And she just went... And she just laughed at me in that moment where I was trying to be like romantic and sensual. My dick got soft so fast, bro. It was unbelievable, dude.
Because she laughed? That might have been a laugh of joy. Like, oh my God.
Nah, it was like, you're making my back feel weird. Like, it was that. Like, that shit killed my ego, bro. My ego was so fragile.
I got something for you, Andrew. That's super fragile. Something for you, bro. Holler at me after the show. Bro.
All right, Ben, what do you got?
Some who's whack something. I got it, though.
All right,
this the conversation men don't have enough of, man. Like, we our feelings get hurt when shit like that happens, man. Like, I want my woman to want me all the time.
All the time.
And if you don't want me in this moment, just tell me. Be like, I'm tired, whatever. Something. It got to be something more than just, I don't feel like it. That's all I'm saying.
Why?
At least say your stomach hurts.
Your ego is just
fragile. Because of my ego. Yes.
Well, that's at least something you have to work on. Just because you want to have sex all the time.
I'm not saying that. But it's just like, yo, tell me something other than I just don't feel like it.
What else would you like to hear?
Right.
I'm tired. My pussy hurt. Something. You know what I mean?
My pussy hurts for the last time. That's a good excuse.
Yeah. Ooh, I like that. See, that's ego.
My pussy hurts for the last time.
See, okay, I'm going
to
lie.
That's what you're
saying. So you want
my shit up. My shit is already
right. Y'all lie anyway.
I don't be lying.
So what do you tell your man when he don't want, when you don't want to have sex?
I don't feel like it.
God. You know what I'm saying?
Oh no, you know, sometimes I have been like, you know, I feel irritated or something like that. I don't want to have sex.
I mean, I feel like,
what if he say that about you? What if he say no to you?
That's weird.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, we're gay. If we say no to you, we're gay.
Should I get it done?
Are we fucking somebody else? I see that. Or even that. That's hurtful. I'll get it done myself. Then you go
and,
grab your vibrator.
Suck my titty while I do this. You ain't got to fuck.
Right, if I don't feel like doing it, I'll suck your titty.
Suck my titties.
You know what I'm saying?
Not yours. My
You suck your own titty while you're doing a vibrator?
No, I need him to do it while I use the vibrator.
Oh, I don't mind that, by the way.
While you use the vibrator? Yeah,
but your man say no, though?
To sucking my titty?
No, to fucking you, period. Like, no, I don't feel like it.
No, never. But I mean, like, you think it's going to happen, then it doesn't. That's kind of disappointing.
What you mean? He go to sleep?
Nobody's ever said, no, I don't feel like it. But like, yeah, he might go to sleep.
Sucking a titty?
No.
No, I'm talking about
I've never
like
had somebody tell me like, no, they don't want to do
they
it.
Don't
my
fuck
my
you
brothers,
are.
Take your power back, man. Start telling girls you don't feel like it. You know what I'm saying?
But that's
start,
a lie. Y'all start, always feel like it.
Exactly.
No.
So if you don't feel like
energy.
It, who you been fucking earlier?
Men don't always feel like it, though.
But you do it anyway, though.
You have to do it. If your girl sit there and say she wants something, you better figure it out. Go drink something, smoke something, figure it out.
No, man. Sometimes you got to jerk off. And so once you jerk off, you got your mind right. And then you could tell your woman, I don't feel like it, just to get back for all the time she told you that, so she can feel how you feel.
Okay.
You're not trying to get back at not doing it.
Hell no. Don't fuck with no woman at home. You fuck with anybody else out of the street. Don't fuck with at home, man. Fuck that.
Hey, what, so what, you ready to cheat now? Because I said I don't feel like it?
No, that doesn't
no.
mean that.
No, you ain't going to get no food. Your clothes ain't going to be washed. You're going to have attitude.
Happy life.
House.
Happy wife, happy life.
Right.
Beat it up real quick. It'll be all right.
This is horrible, man. We're going to pay some bills and we're going to come back and talk about why Quavo took the Bentley. But after listening to y'all talk, I understand why he took it back.
Yeah. Quavo took the Bentley.
First of all, he didn't take it.
Okay. Yeah. Listen, this episode is sponsored by Blue Chew.
Yeah. Yo.
Okay. Guys, it's been a hell of a year. Personally, I feel like, you know, we've all aged about 12 years over the last 12 months. So if you're a guy that feels like you're a little older, your age may be impacting you in the bedroom, okay? So it's time to snap out of it. Spring is here, and it's time to get sprung with Blue Chew, okay? Blue Chew is a unique online service that delivers the same active ingredients as Viagra and Cialis, but in chewable form and at a fraction of the cost. Blue Chew's tablets help men achieve harder, stronger erections to combat all forms of ED. Okay, Blue Chew is an online prescription service, so no visits to the doctor's office, no awkward conversations, and no waiting in line at the pharmacy, and it ships right to your door in a discreet package. The process is simple. Sign up at BlueChew.com, consult with one of their licensed medical providers, and once you're approved, you'll receive your prescription within days. The best part? It's all done online, okay? Blue Chew's licensed medical providers work with you to find the right ingredient and script for your prescription. You don't like swallowing pills? No problem. Blue Chew's sildenafil, did I pronounce that right? Did I land
killed
that?
Killed it.
And tadalafil, did I land that one?
Killed it.
Those tablets are chewable, okay? Blue Chew's tablets are made in the USA, and they prepare and ship direct, so it's cheaper than a pharmacy. So if you could benefit from extra confidence when it's time to perform, visit BlueChew.com for more details and important safety information. And we've got a special deal for our listeners. Try Blue Chew free when you use our promo code IDIOTS at checkout. Just pay $5 shipping. That's BlueChew.com. Promo code IDIOTS to receive your first month free. And we thank Blue Chew for sponsoring the podcast. Now, do we have any church announcements? Schulz, you got any church announcements?
Yes, shows. TheAndrewSchulz.com. Second leg of the tour is up. Few cities already sold out. Go get them right now. TheAndrewSchulz.com. We got a bunch of new. And then when this episode is out, the Song of the Summer, Opener Up, is officially out. You go check it on my YouTube, Spotify. Shit, hopefully it's up on Apple and all those other places as well. But it's up on Spotify, YouTube. Go check it out. Opener Up, myself, Jelly Roll. I got the boys, Alex Media, Mark Gagnon. Yeah, man.
Great porn name. Great gay porn name.
Mark Opener Up?
Last name.
Or
no,
Gagnon.
Yeah, Gagnon.
Yeah.
And listen, you should put this on. You should put this song on this podcast.
Oh, I would love that. Yeah, we'll drop it. We'll put it in. Yeah.
So we actually got any church announcements? Oh, go ahead. Go ahead, Sean.
Nah, we're literally finishing up the music video right now, so it's fire, man. It's fire. I'm excited, man.
Wax, you got any church announcements?
I'm just going to say make sure y'all looks into Bullying the Beast, and I got a weekly description with my my candy gifts. My
Wax weekly lemonade. Description?
Subscription.
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 Yes.
The fuck did Wax just say?
I don't know.
Go to cannagifts.com.net and you go ahead and get your weekly subscription over there. I don't know how to say that shit. I don't know why you're telling me. I don't know what the fuck that shit is. You know what I'm saying? Like, plug it in. I got you. Like, and I said it like 14 times. Like, subscription. Like,
in the mirror?
I don't know. But hey, go on to candygifts.net and go holler at the Lax Lemonade. You know what I'm saying? And thank everybody for coming out to Philly. It was a really dope show.
Did TK kill it?
Killed it. Word. Every night. TK really a Jersey
no,
dude.
No, TK's a beast. He's a
straight
beast.
Jersey dude. It's just like, let him look at that wax. Like, oh, the wax. Like, okay, I see how you roll.
And TK is 60 years,
60 years old, man.
T to the motherfucking
and still
K.
Still got it out here,
6-0.
Killing it. Y'all.
Zero.
We did 8 shows, sold out, man. It was really, really dope, man. Sponsored the whole show, so keep that up.
Listen, all I got is make sure you continue to listen to the Black Effect Podcast Network. Of course, We Talk Back Podcast with AJ and TamBam is on there.
Hey, yes.
Make sure you get We've Got Answers. It's available on Audible right now. That's an audiobook that we put out on Audible a couple weeks ago. And Tamika Mallory, State of Emergency.
Here we
will
go.
Will be out May 11th, 2021. Let me tell you something. This is a special week, right? I'm going to tell you why this is a special week. It's a special week because my first book, Black Privilege, came out on April 17th of 2017, right? And this week, since Andrew be talking shit, the advanced copies of Tamika Mallory's book, State of Emergency, came out this week. I didn't even, that's just, you know, coincidence. So it's my first release on Black Privilege Publishing. So Tamika Mallory, State of Emergency, How to Win in the Country We Built will be out May 11th, but you can pre-order now. But advanced copies are in the street for press in media.
I cannot believe I'm looking at an actual copy of the book.
That's right.
This is unbelievable. It actually exists.
I know we've been talking. I've been talking about this for
Black
months.
Excellent.
That okay. Could be any book, though.
No, it's not. Out. This is the actual, just a goddamn book. You're a liar. You're a liar. Okay. Look, Black Privilege Publishing. This is the book. State of Emergency. How do we see Tamika right there? Okay. This is the book. Okay. It's out May 11th. Everywhere you buy books. My first release off Black Privilege Publishing. So it's not a coincidence. You say what?
I'm getting it.
No, it's not a coincidence because, you know, 2017 when Black Privilege came out and I feel like I graduated, right? So it's 4 years later and now I just don't have a couple of New York Times bestsellers. I have an actual book imprint. Mm-hmm. And this is the first release off the imprint, State of Emergency. How to Win the Country We Built.
Yes.
And thank you. And I've been telling somebody that's sitting here to write a book for so goddamn long for years. Okay.
Chuck.
I'm working on it.
You should. She had a great idea for a book. I don't want to say it because people will steal it. All right? But yeah, how do y'all plug in God?
Guys, man.
This guy is crazy.
Plug in guys?
No, that would be guys, a good chapter. Man.
No, it's not.
No, that would be a good chapter. I know a couple. I don't know a couple, but I know that dude. And then there's another dude. Another dude you went in his butt too.
I don't know if that's true, man.
That's how you know it? I don't know.
No, you did. We talked about that before.
We definitely talked about it.
And that's our guy, so I ain't gonna put him out there.
Ooh.
But
you better knock him off.
No, move your finger.
You tap again. You better stop that.
Ooh. Hey, look. But hey, that might be a service.
A subscription.
Whoa, man,
subscription.
Hold on.
A weekly subscription.
He used to want it?
Man, next. You better stop playing with this dumb shit, man.
Next.
Man, I ain't got time for this shit.
That's what he did. Whenever he wanted it, he did like this.
Lord Jesus.
No, for real. Just say yes and no.
What?
My guy used to want it? This is my
not
guy.
Not want it. No, not
what you was doing.
Man, can we go next? What happened?
God damn. That's
my peoples.
That's my guy, too. That's my guy.
That's our peoples.
Who? Fuck.
Okay. Nobody.
So how do y'all feel about Quavo allegedly taking the Bentley back? He rapped about
taking the Bentley back. It wasn't in the first place. We talked about that.
Y'all are some haters. How that's not his?
It's rented. It's a lease. So how could he just took the lease back?
It's a lease.
If he's paying the lease.
Yeah, he's paying
the
money.
Okay, so he took it back. That's some smart girl shit.
A $350,000 car I'm taking back, too.
Yeah, like she should have given it back.
So he should have let her keep it and just be like, look, it's a lease. The lease up in a couple years. You can keep it, but you got to take care of the lease.
But he's paying. Yeah.
Right.
He should just let her continue to pay.
Transfer the payments to her.
Or take the car back.
Or take the car back and let her get her own.
I don't see
her get her own car. Let her get her own fucking car.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure she has
not together no more.
You think she got cars?
Yeah, I'm
cars
sure.
Are a waste of money, by the way. I think leasing is the way to go.
It is. Yeah, me too. For brand new stuff, you definitely should lease.
Me too.
Yeah, bro.
And then you can jump in and out of something every 3-4 years. So I don't have a problem with the lease. But if he is paying the lease and he took it back, I'm not mad at him.
You know
what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because they're not together no more, right? So it's like, yo, the things that I gave
you. I'm going to be paying for it.
I can't wait
to
see her
riding around with another nigga.
I can't wait to see who Sweetie hitting up next.
Me too.
Because I feel like, okay, to me, like you add money for instant swag. Like, I feel like men should get the same type of bitches that they would get if they didn't have any money. Like, could he get her if he didn't have any money?
Yes.
How? In what world?
Because she might not have no money. We don't know what she looked like before money.
Yeah,
why we act like money just goes with women?
She's beautiful, though.
She was the same face.
Like, so girls might have thought Quavo was cute before money.
Nah, he was getting different women.
What you mean, man?
He was not getting that same caliber of women.
I think some, you know, guys just, you know, have a way with women. It don't matter.
Look at, come on, dog.
What you mean?
Look at these guys. Boy, money do something.
Your first picture.
Man, go to Saweetie. See, I don't like. Go to Saweetie when she was young.
Saweetie is the woman y'all would have wanted in high school. I can't even tell which one you watch. Exactly.
Who's the one all the way in the end over here?
They need sleep. Okay.
All the way at the top. Who the one over to the right?
He's not an unattractive man.
He's not.
No, right there. Go to the next one. Right there. Who is that?
I don't know who that is.
Got to dupe me.
That's Quavo in the middle? That don't even look
I thought that was Quavo to the right.
Too judgmental. Like, people don't grow. Like, we don't evolve. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, you know what I mean? Some people get better with time. Okay? Let's see. Go to Saweetie before fame.
She's been beautiful forever. Look at her.
That's her right there?
Mm-hmm.
I don't see why they couldn't have been together in high school. Mm-hmm. What's the problem? Just judgmental for no reason.
I want her to be with somebody else. That's just like I felt about Sierra when she was with Future. Like, why you let him put a baby in you?
Lord have mercy.
Drop his DNA in you?
What's the problem?
Yeah, Future's not good looking.
Why y'all so superficial? Don't be so shallow.
First of all, men are way more shallow than women. You do not see a fine ass guy with regular bitch.
That doesn't happen. She's right.
See a nice looking woman with an ugly man all the time.
This is how women contradict themselves. They say that we're shallow, but then they say we fuck anything. It can't be both.
Y'all do both.
Y'all do both.
We're shallow, but we will fuck anything.
Guy code,
right,
bro.
Thank you.
It's facts,
though. What are you talking
about, but here's the thing. Women are shallow, too, just about different shit. You're shallow about money. You know, there's no such thing as an ugly billionaire. Didn't Jay-Z say
First of all, men like men with money, too.
Right.
That's where the big homie shit came from.
Big homie. What's up, big homie?
Big homie.
Look, they'll call a baby big homie if he got more money than
exactly.
You.
Yo,
that's so true.
Yo, men do like men with money. Me and Duval was just
everybody
talking about this
likes
shit yesterday.
Okay.
Hey, man, I'm going to wait till I'm 50. And we got to call out all the men that like men with money.
Why are you going to wait? Do it today.
Do it now.
No, I'm going to mind my business.
I'll call
that shit is disgusting, bro.
You said they'll call a baby big homie if they got more money than him? That's hysterical, yo.
No, you know what's so interesting about that? Dudes be hanging out with people that they would never hang out with if that person ain't had money.
That's a fact.
You've been clowning that dude in high school, giving
him
wedgies.
And these guys wouldn't get those women if they didn't have money.
No, I don't believe that.
What?
That's the truth.
Only because I've seen, you know, dudes, everybody, like, dudes can get a girl without no money.
For sure.
A quality woman?
Yes.
Yeah.
Women like conversation. They like laugh
to laugh.
They probably got a rich dude that ain't doing shit for them.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You could be with a rich dude who ain't treating her right.
Right.
You know what I mean? And then you just show her a good time. Next thing you know, you're like,
Tim's, guaranteed.
Come on, man. Seen it a million times. Like, nah, I don't think money is the end all be all. No, I don't.
Okay.
Not even a little bit.
That's fair.
I don't think so. Have y'all gotten the vaccine yet?
No.
No.
Okay. My mom got it on Saturday, and she was sick with 104 degree temperature on Sunday.
She's which one she get?
She got the
Johnson.
No,
thank God.
She did do the two shots, so that's the Moderna, right?
Okay, good.
Or Pfizer.
Yeah. So whichever one, but they discontinued the Johnson & Johnson.
From what we understand,
man, it was guinea pigging people.
Y'all not getting it?
I'm not an anti-vaxxer, but I'm not in no rush to get it.
Yeah, I'm gonna wait.
Me neither. I'm gonna wait.
I'm getting that shit today.
See you turn to a zombie?
No, you're not. You're a fucking liar.
I am. I'm getting the Moderna one. Well, technically, when this podcast comes out today, but yeah, Thursday, I'm going to get that shit.
Really?
Yeah.
Why? What happened? I want to know what changed Andrew Schulz's mind, because Andrew Schulz was the guy who was like, I got the antibodies. What changed your mind?
My girl got the appointment. We were in a fight, and I just didn't want to add another thing to the fight. So I was like, fuck it. Give me the vaccine or whatever.
It happens every time.
She got pressured into a show.
What was y'all fighting about?
Huh?
I mean, he did.
What was y'all fighting about?
Her laughing at me during sex.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
You got a double pump syndrome.
And how'd that turn into the shot?
Yo, you know what? No, I didn't really. But you know what is funny is that, like, I literally, for a living, love it when people laugh. Like, that's what, and there is one time where I don't want to hear a single fucking chuckle.
And that's during sex.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I don't know. I was super against it.
You don't let the jokes fly during sex?
Not sometimes in the beginning I will. Sometimes like it'll be like little cutesy jokes, you know? But then once it gets into aggressive, you could be cutesy and shit.
No smiles and laughs.
What's she saying in here?
No smiles and laughs during sex?
You don't want her to smile at all.
No, of course. Nah. Smile, laugh.
I don't even want your eyes open. Your eyes open. What the fuck is happening with your eyes open for?
You don't want her eyes? She can't look at you during sex?
I don't know. I'm trying to think.
What's that? That means that says that black women always close their eyes during sex because they can't stand to see a nigga happy.
Whoever wrote that,
why you don't want her eyes open?
What? Yeah,
I don't know. I think if you're not enjoying it. Like, do you kiss with your eyes open? Like, when you're trying to enjoy something, like, you close your eyes.
Right.
Yo,
what about a very intense
have you ever
stare,
done this
though?
Have you ever been kissing somebody and then you got your eyes open and then you see their eyes open, you're like, what's your eyes open for? Like,
that'd be crazy as hell.
Like praying with your eyes open.
You see what I'm saying? That's kind of crazy as hell.
You don't pretty do like
so. You don't want a woman to like stare you in your eyes intensely while she's sucking your
dick. That's some soul ties right there.
That sucking your dick is different. My meeting you and you got your eyes is open. Like imagine a girl looking at the pillow while you smash it. Like right, that's kind of crazy.
Nah, the sucking the dick.
I don't know. I don't think.
Yo, so what if
stop sucking
the mirror
dick
in front of you
and looking at me in the eyes? We don't need you to suck dick. Like just focus on the task at hand. You know what I mean? Like if I'm ordering a fucking Subway sandwich, I don't need the guy who's making the sandwich to be putting together the fucking sandwich and staring me in the eyes. Do
that's
what you
different
gotta do. Focus on your
make
craft.
Make the sandwich, man. Make the sandwich.
What's the point of looking at the guy when you're doing it?
To let you know you ain't shit.
Staring in their eyes, it's like some intensity.
Really?
Yeah, some like people will tell you, like, look at me.
Mm-hmm. It's like some energy exchange when you're staring in their eyes.
Well, keep your energy on the thing that you gotta keep it on. Like, why you got all this extra
Jesus
energy,
Christ.
Yo? You know what I'm saying? Like,
that's a lot of energy.
Jesus Christ. Let's do some shit you won't care about next week, Taylor. What is that right there? What does that say? Can you be too old to get a hickey?
Yes. That's a great question. Yes.
Oh, yes. Keisha Cole tweeted that. Yes. Keisha Cole tweeted, how can you be too old for a hickey? You bitch is crazy. Whoever said it, fuck you, respectfully.
I don't want to be out here with a hickey on my neck doing business.
Anybody know you having sex? Like, chill out.
By the way, if the pussy good, you're going to get that hickey.
Because
if a guy's on top of you, he kissing on you. Stop. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you can know better.
He's going to suck on your neck.
People do that when they're young because they want everybody to know you finally having sex. Like, yo, look at a hickey. Or let me smell your finger. That's the same thing as smelling your finger.
Who the fuck? No, nobody does that.
Come on.
Right, that you definitely
do. Disgusting.
I'm talking about back in the day, hickey and smelling your finger, the exact same thing. Go to your boy, like, let me smell your finger.
Take a shower, bro.
Or a fucking hickey and say, shit.
Yeah, this guy's doing walking around for 3 days.
Swag's got them filthy ass hands.
Disgusting.
Get, nigga.
Can you be too old for a hickey? TamBam?
No. If you're having sex and it happens.
It happens.
Right.
Nah, you're too old.
I don't want hickeys.
You want to see a 40-year-old person? You want your fucking...
I would be putting makeup
don't
on
don't mind
it.
Their business. Like, why do you give a fuck?
Nah. I would be trying to put makeup on it to cover. It could happen.
And at a
but
certain,
I would be trying to cover it up.
And you're not going to think it's a hickey if a person's past a certain age. You're like, that's a rash? Is that a birthmark?
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You
they
okay?
get smacked in their neck or something
yeah.
like that.
You're not going to think it's a hickey.
Abuse.
Mm-hmm.
You think you're too old to give hickey shows?
Am I too old to give a hickey?
Yeah.
Honestly, yeah. Like, I don't want my girl. I don't think it looks nice. Like, your girl walking around with hickeys all over her neck. It just looks mm-hmm. weird. Like,
how many you
she
get?
She fucking. Like,
yeah,
what it look like?
Yeah, she tell fucking.
She's fucking.
She just finished fucking.
Yeah, right, well, Keisha Cole too said, much.
Keisha,
I agree.
Keisha
too
Cole
much.
Said, fuck y'all. Keisha Cole said, fuck y'all, respectfully.
And right, Keisha Cole
so
is a grown
of
ass.
Three of us is, like, kind of crazy. Do you only stop at one?
Yeah,
Hickey's
like the poor people's engagement ring.
What?
You know what I mean? It's like that's mine, but
it's
I'm not enough.
It's my brand. I branded her
exactly. What else we got?
I don't know what the fuck Leslie Jones was talking about. Right,
it's my
here.
Sister.
What she said? Dudes and dudettes who ghost are cowards. Maybe they think that if they don't respond, the whole thing just never happened. They do not have the courage to be honest and their manners are poor. I think ghosting is... Oh, I get it. I think ghosting is one of the cruelest things you can do. Avoid someone because you don't want to tell them the truth. Leave someone hanging. It's so disrespectful
you told
of the
them.
Other person's feelings.
The silence tells them. I don't think that ghosting is that bad. Like, I've ghosted and I've been semi-ghosted before. You
that's
know what
why
I'm
you
saying?
Don't think it's bad.
I don't...
But it's never happened to you.
You think it's disrespectful to go?
It just depends on how deep y'all are.
Exactly. Like, you go out to dinner with somebody, you wasn't feeling him after dinner.
Then you don't talk to him. I owe you an explanation.
No. But what if he fucked?
But if y'all are fucking each other,
that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Okay. Then okay.
The longer y'all been together, ghosts.
If the dick was really bad, then it's okay to ghost.
You don't want to see her cry?
What about this, though? What about this? Is it worse to string someone on? I think ghosting is way better than stringing someone on and saying, no, I do like you, but yeah, I can't hang out this week. Let's hang out next week. Blah, blah, blah. That's the most cruel thing.
Yeah.
But don't you want a reason?
Fuck, who cares the reason?
Hey, your teeth, I didn't like how they look.
That's the problem.
It'd be like subtle shit with women a lot of times.
But listen, if a guy fucks you and doesn't call you no more, that don't piss y'all off?
Yes, it does piss you off. Life can piss you off.
It's okay.
That's fucked up.
It's not illegal to piss people off.
And y'all don't wonder why? Because that's what really is pissing you off about the whole situation. Even if a girl does that to a guy, it's the why. Why you
you really owe them something? Like,
yes.
I don't want to know why, but at this age, it's just like, well.
I might want to improve.
It could be, okay, then if it's mutual, y'all ghost each other. Mm-hmm. Like, we just don't talk no more.
That's cool.
So it's cool. So it's cool if it's a mutual ghost.
No, I need
but
to know
one
the
person,
why.
Like,
yeah, why don't you got to worry about the other person feeling?
Oh, my God. Why?
That's why I say you don't ghost.
I know you ain't talking.
Listen, if I know you for a real long time,
I know you ain't talking about ghosting nobody.
That's what I do.
Oh, okay.
You ghost?
If I know you for a long time, I want to ghost you because I don't want to see you cry.
That's casual.
No, that's worse. If you know somebody for a long time and then ghost them, that's different.
You don't want to see them cry, so that's when you ghost them. If you know somebody for a short period of time, you don't care.
I've seen wax ghost girlfriends. Girls that he told
that's different. That's not even ghosting. That's like
women he told me he likes. Women he's introduced me to.
That's weird. That's not ghosting.
And then ghost them.
That's not ghosting. That's something different.
Savage. Whole savage.
That's some band behavior.
Yeah, bitch ass nigga.
I agree.
No friend.
Should I go into details?
Thank you.
Yes.
Should I go into details?
No.
Tell us. Tell us, Charlamagne.
Do it. Do it.
In the name of Jesus.
No.
What happened, Charlamagne?
I got nothing to do with this.
I know a woman that he was really into. He introduced me to her. He introduced my wife to her. I'm like, oh, man, you know what I'm saying? It's a nice woman for you, yada, yada, yada. All of a sudden, yo, I had to stop fucking with her. Yo, I had to stop talking to her because I don't want to hurt her feelings. I'm like, so you just stopped talking to her?
That hurt.
I did that a lot though. She was getting some girls.
Listen,
too nice.
Let me tell you how much she didn't know. Popping up on his ass.
Whoa.
Popping up.
Whoa.
Popping up on his ass. Like, you just gonna stop talking to me?
Hold on, who?
I don't know. This guy goes crazy all the time.
She wasn't black.
Oh,
you know,
wax. Oh, okay.
You know, wax never gets into an intimate relationship with a black woman. So that did.
This motherfucker.
Damn, wax.
Look, I'm about to get
that. That's coffee.
I'm gonna get on your ass off air about that shit. And like, I got an opinion about that.
But that was bad. That was bad though. I told him that was fucked up. Don't do that to people, man.
No, that's not what happened.
What happened?
What happened was
tell him what happened. It's old.
He liked her.
No,
she just ghosted because he didn't want her to feelings.
That's what he told me.
I don't like hurting nobody's feelings, and I got into something that I just was not supposed to get into. And when I realized, I looked up and realized, like, what the fuck is going on? And I
Schultz, who's the ultimate enemy to Puerto Ricans?
The ultimate enemy to Puerto Ricans?
Yes, who's not enemy, but like they got like a rivalry.
Diabetes.
Man, shut up.
Oh my God.
That's black people. Oh my God. That's black people. Not Puerto Ricans.
They don't eat a lot of rice. I'm telling you.
Shut up. It does start with a D, though. It does
Dominicans.
Start with a D. Yeah!
Oh, he had himself a Dominican?
Whacked out a civil war!
No.
Yes, man. Yes. And I told him that was so fucked. I said, yo, you just be playing. He gotta play. He always gotta play the game filthy.
On his face.
Turning women into hoes.
Yeah, but why?
No, that's
why?
What he be doing. He turning women into hoes.
Why you gotta play
man.
The game so filthy?
Huge boy. Wait, what's up? I'm gonna tell y'all something, man. Charlamagne would throw alley-oops this whole fucking show.
What you
but
mean?
But nobody's dunking it.
What
I'm happy
do you
as
mean,
hell.
Man?
I'm swatting this shit every time he say it. That shit, the fuck out of it. I'm gonna keep throwing them shit. I'm not listening.
Listen, All I'm saying, that was fucked up. That was a terrible, that was the worst ghost I ever seen.
Now, I'm gonna tell you, a while ago, I apologized to everybody. I'm sorry for everything I ever did. You know what I'm saying? And sometimes you gotta leave. You just don't wanna hurt nobody's feelings.
But you ended up hurting her feelings anyway.
You do it. You're right, but okay.
No accountability.
That's what I was talking about. No accountability.
It's either stand there and watch her cry, or
dump her and be all on Instagram with
and
Puerto
don't
Rico.
See her cry. Let her cry by herself.
And pop up with a new bitch. Right?
I don't even know how we got here.
Women crying in the mirror, man. Is it me?
Yes, man. And a lot of
ladies just know it's not
that's
you.
What
it's
I'm
not
saying.
The problem.
That's this what nigga. I'm saying.
It's these men. I'm not going to say it's my brother now. It's just these men.
I was a piece of shit, and I apologize.
We all were.
Yeah. I apologize. Jesus Christ, Charlamagne.
See, that's why ghosting is bad. That's all. That's the moral. Oh,
that's the moral.
We had a whole race war, and he's talking about ghosting.
The moral of the story, ghosting is horrible. Okay?
Don't do it.
All right, we still doing shit you won't care about next week. Did you see? Now, this was, I thought this was interesting. Did you see 50 and I liked how 50 handled it. Diddy was spotted out with 50's baby mama.
Yeah.
Oh, I can see that.
Yeah.
The industry is very, like, it's like an ancestral place. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I don't even know why Diddy would want that. You know what I'm saying? She's a beautiful woman, but I, like, that's, to me, that's like, you know that's 50 baby mama. Why would you want to highlight it?
Maybe that's why.
It's trouble. Nah, that's trouble, bro.
Maybe that's why. Maybe you want a little excitement.
All right, well, that's what you're going to get.
Yeah.
You got the kids involved.
Yeah.
Men just want, men like that. And I feel like that is in the, you know, in the industry, the entertainment industry. They want
the same women.
Yeah, like they.
You're going to get exactly what you
want. It's territory. You take a dog to a new apartment, he's going to piss on it. Right? He wants to mark some territory. So. This is what they're doing.
I just think it's
more about how he feels about the man than how he feels about the woman.
Right. The man's supposed to give respect.
He's definitely fucking with 50 with that.
Yeah, that's all
it is. That's, yes.
So and he's holds for everybody, so there's that part.
I just did certain things. I wouldn't do that to one of my boys.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
But they're not boys. They're enemies.
Clearly. Yeah, you know what I mean?
She is super savage.
Yeah. I ain't mad at her.
Me neither. I'm not mad at her.
Me either.
I'm not mad at her. I just think it is.
They ain't friends.
Yes.
Right.
But I agree, it's a respect thing. Like, it's just...
That's respect right there. You shake the man's hands like that, he ain't pounding, you gain respect right there.
That's a long time
ago. That was 20 years ago.
Hey, don't matter.
It's just certain things I just don't think you should do. I know that the, you know, industry is incestuous, but come on, man.
So what 50 had to say about it?
He was big about it, right?
He just said he don't care.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's like, we fight over business, not women. So,
Jesus.
Do whatever you want.
There's certain things you don't do.
It's a respect thing, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's a respect thing. Like, and like, you at least got to call the dude and let him give him a heads up.
Could she be with somebody other than Diddy, though? God damn.
What's wrong with Diddy?
Next. I ain't touching it no more.
Okay.
But, Charlotte, what you think when Jay-Z did that to Nas's baby mom?
He did that on purpose. He's being spiteful.
Yeah, it was beef.
He did that on purpose. And by the way, nobody knew that.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That was something that happened. And then
there was no social media.
Yes, and then when he needed to use it against Nas, he did.
Biggie and Pac and Faith.
Same thing.
Yeah.
He used it against him.
Exactly.
Faith said she didn't fuck Pac.
And I believe her.
Yeah, me too.
I believe her.
Yeah, me too.
It's easy. That's 100,000 years ago. She could say, "Yeah, I fucked a man." I want to know what that dick was like.
Me too.
Yes. Prayers up for Black Rob. I do want to say prayers up for Black Rob. You know what I mean?
Yes.
You know, I don't. And that is a good conversation too, because I see people mad at Diddy for this.
Mm.
What is Diddy supposed to do in this situation?
Not smashing somebody else's baby mama.
Because at the end of the day, it's business, right? After you and a person's business is done with each other and y'all haven't done business in years, am I supposed to always show up for this individual? It's not like we're friends or family or anything like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, what do you want people to do after a business relationship has dissolved?
I'll give you an example. Okay. Mark Cuban, the owner of the Dallas Mavericks, for a brief part of his career, had a player that was on his team named Delonte West.
Very true.
Delonte West is battling mental illness and drug use and was homeless.
That's right.
And Mark Cuban scooped him up, put him in a rehab center, is now, I think, employing him. I think he's actually a part of the team. He didn't have to do that.
That's my point, though. I'm glad he did it. And I salute Mark Cuban for doing that. But he's not obligated.
No, Diddy's not obligated. Diddy is
obligated.
He's not obligated, but it is a cool thing to do for somebody who needs something. Especially somebody that you've made money with. And Diddy probably made way more money off of Black Rob than Mark Cuban made off of Delonte West.
Listen, I agree. But once again, I don't think Diddy's obligated to do that.
So what is he doing for him?
So...
Who, did he?
Yeah,
nothing that
Black
know
Rob
of.
Was on Bad Boy, right?
Yes.
Oh, so I thought they were a family.
What's his illness?
Ooh. Are they not a
family? But see, Tammy brings up a
I'm
good
sorry.
Point.
What is the saying? Bad boy for
life. Bad boy for life. No, Tammy
brings
up a good
point. It's not bad boy for the extent of the contract. It's not bad boy for 3 years. It's not bad boy for 1 year. It's bad boy for life.
And see, that's where the problems come. The problems come with these record labels because instead of just doing business, they all family. You know what I'm saying? When you know this ain't really your family. This is just somebody that you're doing
business with. That's how you manipulate motherfuckers into doing shit for less money.
Exactly.
Right.
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 We family.
Family.
We know that's his specialty.
That's true. That's true. But even,
all I'm saying is, it's completely, I think it's completely okay to be critical of someone who has marketed it as a family and then you see them actually not living that life.
That I agree with. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? If you're saying that a person is family, you're saying it's bad boy for life, then you probably should show up for that person.
Right.
For sure. But in most situations, especially when it comes to business, that's not the case. It's just transactional.
100%.
You know what I mean?
That's being a good human being.
I mean, look, there were other teams that Delonte West played for. Those owners didn't go help Delonte West, and nobody expected them to.
Yeah,
Mark Cuban did it, and it was really cool that he did it.
Where's his family?
Respect
Where's
to
his
him.
Family?
Respect.
Like, where are these people family at?
I mean, in most situations, well, in a situation like Delonte West or Black Rob, they probably was the first wealthy people in their family.
Right.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So now that they don't have it no more, who going to be there for them?
So what was what was he in the hospital for? Like, what's
say
going
he needs
on
a kidney.
Oh, man.
Yeah, he'd say he needs a kidney.
Did he got to cough that up, yo?
What, a kidney?
Give a kidney.
I'm sure Diddy could find somebody who can do that.
Give
Diddy
a kidney, bro.
Give him a kidney, Puff.
Give him a kidney, Puff. Come on now.
Black market. Yeah,
I'm sure he could get that.
Right. Buy one right quick.
By the way, that's an Instagram post. Seriously.
If Diddy
or somebody posted about Black Rob need a kidney, Rob would get flooded.
Yes,
would
bunch
get
of kidneys.
Flooded with people that want to give up kidneys.
So help Black Rob go get my kidney once somebody. Shit.
All right. Shit you won't care about next week. The game. The game said maybe I'm old school, but my woman ain't paying one damn bill. Not rent, not mortgage, not a car note, not nails, hair, clothes, phone, or groceries. If you're taking care of home, cooking, and fucking the shit out of me, life on me, period.
Okay. Sounds nice and traditional.
Just post a picture of your dick looking big in the sweatpants, bro. We don't want to hear this nonsense.
Right.
What?
I'm with Sean.
You want to see the dick?
No, I'm saying it's like you're doing the same thing. Like you're thirst trapping the girls. All this is a thirst trap to
that's
girls.
The
right?
Jackson shit.
I take care of you. That's it.
I feel that way.
Like, come on, bro. Like, duh. Wait, you're rich and you take care of the woman you're with? Bravo, bro.
Right.
Yeah, that's all I'm saying.
Holy shit. Are you in the army and you fight for America? Bravo.
This is problematic for couples in the trenches together.
Right. Who can't, afford to do that.
Exactly. So look what the game's saying. There's nothing wrong with splitting bills.
Yo,
this is
some Derek Jackson shit.
Okay. I like
that. All men should aspire to one day take care of their families.
Yeah. True.
That's it. That's
true.
All we want that's you to it. Do is aspire. We want you to be working towards that.
Right.
But if you don't mind helping if he needs it.
Absolutely. That's how it's supposed to be. Women are supposed to be
you
to help me.
You respect her more anyway.
But if he got it, y'all expect him to do what the game is saying.
Hell
right.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
For sure.
Why
would
But we do. Like, no man is waking up that morning going like, I sure hope I don't have to pay for anything for my girl today. Like, it's the stupidest post I've ever seen. Like, every man wants to be able to provide for their girl. Every man wants to be able to take care of their girl. And
that's not true.
That's not true. Right,
men, if they got it, they do. But if they don't got it, they can't.
Right.
Yeah,
well, then mentally they want to be there, but then they project their issues onto you. Like, I can't do it today. So
because
that's
they're insecure.
Exactly. So that's where the term gold digger came from. It's just from some dude who ain't have the rent money, can spend it on motherfucking, I don't know, weed and studio time instead. Mm-hmm. So now I'm a gold digger because I got requirements. Mm-hmm. So and I'm asking something of you.
Why can't this flip then? Because y'all doing well, right? Why can't y'all take care of the man?
That's not how it goes.
What you mean?
The hell are you talking about, Charlamagne?
Why can't y'all take care of the man? What if it's a man that you
men feel like so insecure when a woman can take care of them? Like, I'm not dealing with you about that.
It all depends on what it is.
A lot of men are emasculated by that.
Bullshit.
I don't even know what that means.
Bullshit. I have no problem letting a woman take care of me.
But she got it all day long.
I have no, I would have no problem.
The fuck
with
I need to pay a bill for? You got it, guys.
Exactly. That's
how do you respect? Like, how do you look? How you hold your man at night?
Well, see, that's what it is. Like, y'all don't respect
we
men.
We the big spoon.
Wow. But that's what it is. Y'all don't respect men who can.
I'll be honest with you. I'll be honest
men
with you.
Men don't respect men who can.
Ladies, I'll be honest with you. You're sounding a little broke.
Shade.
What do you mean?
How do we take care of a man?
I'm just saying, you sound a little broke right now. If you had crazy money,
exactly.
Yeah, please tell us how.
If you had crazy money, bills wouldn't be a big deal. If you have crazy money, you just knock them out. It's nothing. It's a few hundred dollars. Who cares?
Money
isn't
that big
a deal.
But I
definitely would want a man who got money or more money than me.
Right.
You want a provider?
Yes.
But why does it have to be money that a man provides? Why a man can't provide emotional support?
All of that.
You know what I'm saying? Love.
Caring about you.
I ain't heard y'all talk about none of that stuff this episode. So,
respecting what? You to
we've
the fullest.
We've been talking about this a lot.
That's what it
love don't pay the
what
bills.
About love? You know what I'm saying?
Love do not boy, pay the bills.
I'll pay the bills this, around here.
I'm so
make
happy
this
I'm
argument.
Married.
For women is there's going to be if a woman wants to have a family with you, there's going to be a time where she can't work. Like she got to literally birth a kid. Right. And she got to raise the kid at least for a few months. So there's going to be a section of that relationship.
True.
And most women still go to work 6 months, 6 weeks later.
Absolutely. Back. But there's a section for at least, let's say, bare minimum 3 months where a woman is not going to be able to work.
She
got to look at her man and go, yo, can you hold shit down for minimum 3 months? And if
three
she doesn't feel
months,
that way, I can totally understand why she's not secure being with that person. Like, well, the reason I pay for all this shit is because I want my girl to know, yo, it's good no matter what. If you want to stay home with the kid, that's good too.
I think we put too much pressure on money though, man. I think we miss out on good people when we put everything on money. You know how many times y'all probably done missed y'all blessing with men?
No, I have been with men in the trenches. I have, you know, I got people who are doing well now because they were with me at some point.
Really?
Okay. Yes.
Okay, upgrade.
Yeah. So if it's not financial... It could be.
How does that make you feel?
But finances is the reasons why most relationships end.
Really?
It's because, money. It's not the love. The love is there. The money is not. That's the problem.
So you would break up with a person just because they ain't got no money, even if you love them to death?
No, I'm not saying that. I'm just saying sometimes the finances makes the relationship harder.
Yes. Tammy lying. Tammy's a cancer. Tammy loves love.
I do love love. But money, if you're broke, you're not happy.
But
most people aren't happy broke.
No, I know a lot of happy crackheads, and they stay together the longest. All these crackheads stay together the longest. I ain't never seen nobody stay together.
They don't want for shit, though. They just want crack.
That's miserable.
That's love, though.
But why do y'all act like two broke people can't be happy? Like, why are we equating money with happiness?
Y'all know that shit's stressful.
It's stressful. Like, stop acting like...
But I seen the brokest people stay together.
First of all,
you
don't have money for a long time.
But that's what I'm saying. If you used to not having... That's when you used to really have fun.
Are you broke? Yeah. All the nice stuff.
No, I'm not.
No,
I have better fun now.
You have
way more fun when you got money.
I didn't mean to tell y'all that lie. How do you know?
Yeah.
You know, but, trying to be relatable.
Listen. Nah, but listen, all the rich people I see bricking up all the time, all the poor people, they stay together. They try to work this thing out.
Because they don't got no choice. Like, you got more money, you have more options.
I need you. I need you, you need me. Boom. If I got a bunch of money, I don't need you.
I will say it's the best when you got money and you with the people you came up with.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? When you get to live that other life with your people that was in the trenches with you. That's when
what makes sense.
That's when we have fun. Mm-hmm. And we be having fun on them islands. You hear me?
Mm-hmm.
You hear me? You hear me? Let's scroll down, Taylor. What else we got? Who else we got?
Hold on, you guys go. I gotta use the bathroom.
Yeah, rest. Shit, I gotta pee too, by the way. Hold on. Let's pause it then. Listen, rest in peace to DMX.
Yes.
What's that he's talking about?
I was thinking about this the other day. Has there ever been a period where this many like icons were passing away?
It's scary.
And people gotta go, I imagine though. So we just
people gotta go. You gotta get the fuck up.
They're
out
now
here.
Our peer age.
But are we that old? The way we yes. watching people pass away?
We are.
NBA God, players are changing.
Y'all that old? I'm
not me. I'm yeah, y'all getting there.
I think. I think DMX is gonna bring people closer to God because I think we're at a point in society where that's all we got. By the way, mm-hmm. like, and I'm not saying that's all we got because that's really all we ever had. But he's gonna bring people back to what's really important. The pandemic made everybody realize what was really important last year, right? Mm-hmm. Like, which is God, which is your family, which is the essentials. But watching a man that was that anointed, right, who everywhere he went, regardless of everything he was going through, always give all glory to God.
Always.
I think the same way Nipsey, God bless the dead, made people start thinking about the age-old concept of, you know, black entrepreneurship, black ownership, you know, the do-for-self model, the way Kobe made people, you know, question their work ethic and, you know, embrace being a father of girls, the girl dad thing. I think X is going to make people realize.
Multiple prophets.
Yes. X is going to make people realize spirituality is all we got at the end of the day.
Right.
And God is all we got at the end
of the day. Why do you think that?
I've been doing is listening to a lot of his prayers. I've just been listening to his prayers over and over. And his prayers is really, really dope.
Off the dome.
Yeah, a lot of them I didn't even know that he did that many.
So super heartfelt.
What'd you say, Schulz?
Yeah, I was, why do you think that? Yeah, what?
For that reason Wax just said. Because if you notice, all of the stuff that you see online is him praying. Mm. He would randomly just show up, be at Waffle House and lead everybody in prayer.
Really
or be at backstage at concerts and lead everybody in prayer. Just praying for people on the street. So the things you're seeing about him now is that. You're seeing that part of his life, which some people may have never noticed. That was always the thing that stood out to X to me.
I've seen like some of them, but a lot of, now he got a lot of dope prayers. Like I'm seeing a bunch of everything online is going like this. So I enjoy that part.
Like this one woman, I saw this one woman post online how she randomly ran in the DMX at a hotel.
Got her back with her father.
Got her back with her father because she couldn't forgive her father because I don't know if he was a drug addict. It was something.
He had addiction problem.
Yeah, and X just had this whole long conversation with her about forgiveness and forgiving her dad and praying for her dad. And she got a relationship with her father because of that. Wow. You know what I'm saying? He really was a prophet, you know? And once again, I keep telling people, if you did not recognize God in DMX, it's because you're too busy looking for God in places where you believe God should be.
Absolutely. Wow. And focusing on the negative, like, oh, he's on drugs. Like, so what?
So what? Mm-hmm. Everybody got trauma. Everybody got addictions. And everybody vices. Got things, vices, we're fighting.
Sex is a drug.
Sex is definitely a drug.
Food is a drug.
Yes.
Food That's is my definitely fault. A drug. What, food?
Yes.
Food is a drug.
What are we eating after this?
Lord have mercy. Rest in peace to DMX. Schulz, I loved your take on Chloe, bro.
Thank you, man.
I did. I thought that was very well said. Chloe, what was it? She put out a tweet or it was something about, what was it?
She I guess accidentally or someone on her team accidentally posted an unphotoshopped image and they were trying to wipe it from the internet. And when they try to wipe some shit from the internet, that shit is real because we used that picture for the thumbnail of the YouTube clip and then YouTube took that whole shit down.
Damn.
Really?
So, yeah, they're not playing games. But basically, she said, it's so hard keeping up with societal standards of body images, or there's so much pressure to keep up with it. And it was just like, dude, you and your fucking family created these unrealistic standards for women, dude. You know, it's like you can't be the victim of the thing you create. And I don't mind if you make blood money. A lot of people make blood money. But if you make blood money, you're not going to cry about how hard it is for you to make your blood money. You know, if you choose to make your billions doing some fucked up shit, then shut your mouth and keep making your money. But don't make me feel bad for you when you started this problem.
Yeah, I wish that maybe she will in the future. It should be a deeper conversation, right? Because, yeah, like those impossible beauty standards that you got to put 100 filters on and have surgery and all of this other stuff. That Kardashian family's responsible for a lot of that.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean?
But are they really, or are they just another cog in the machine, you know?
They're the big cog.
Yeah.
Because, you know, Kylie went from 0 to 100 and didn't tell nobody nothing.
Yeah. One day she's a different person.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Like, you can't change your DNA, though.
Yeah. It's crazy because, like, And I'm not saying that this is across like all cultures, but like there are women that literally get their face changed to look like Kardashians. Like there's so many fake Kardashians out there. Like,
or their Instagram filter. Actually want to look like their filters.
It's crazy. So it's like they're dictating the beauty standards for the world in a lot of ways. And they dictate the clothing standards for the world. When I posted that shit and I saw the reaction, I realized that like women's relationship with the Kardashians is not what I thought it was. Like,
explain.
It's the same way as like people's relationship with royalty. You know, like people don't really like the king. They don't like the queen. They just like the cool shit the king and queen got. But if something bad happens to the king or queen, they're like, bet finally that piece of shit got what they deserve.
I'm never like that. I'm not a hater. I'm cool with people. I like the Kardashians.
Do you though? For what?
I like them because I feel like they make it okay for little white girls to date black guys. Like it's cool.
And that's okay.
But they're not really white though. I mean, they're white, but they're Armenian.
Yeah, but Kylie and her sister, they're white.
They are, they not Armenian? I don't know.
Their dad, the Kardashians' dad.
All right, so back to the thing with the Kardashians. I just like, I think that there is growing resentment because they're an institution that dictates the standards that women have to uphold, right? So women are like, fuck, I don't want to shoot shit into my lips and my cheeks and all this other stuff. Fuck, I don't want to have to get ass implants. Fuck, I don't want to have to buy all this expensive shit, but this is what I got to do to keep up in the world. So when they fall, if you notice, anytime they stumble, the world rejoices. Nobody's capping for them. Nobody's going, but they're okay, but they're sweet. They're nice people. They're like, get them. Blood in the water. So
like the standards.
They definitely aren't the beauty standard, though, because look at what they're enhancing, their lips and their ass. Mm-hmm. Who's that?
Black women.
Exactly.
Yep.
And here's the thing. If they was to have that conversation, people might respect them more. Mm-hmm. Like if they were to tell people,
they're not.
This is what I did. This is how we did it. Yada, yada, yada. Yes. If they did that, I think people would respect it.
Could you imagine that? I would like for them to do that.
They're not going to do that.
No, they're not going to do that. Because truth be told, you probably want this unedited picture done because you don't want to have to answer no questions about the surgery.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Because now we see this unedited picture, like, oh, she did get this done. She did get that done. Like, but I agree. I do think that they created this unattainable standard of beauty that is just... I feel sorry for women. Y'all got too much pressure, man.
Yep. It is a lot of pressure.
And I feel like we do it to ourselves. Like, bitches be getting asked to sit on it all day long in a call center. I don't understand. What are you doing? Your ass ain't even working.
And all the other things going against each other anyway. Like, we don't care. Men smash anything.
No, we don't. Man. Why do you keep saying
men
that?
Men be smashing anything. Stop it.
No, we don't.
That girl with that flat ass ain't getting no dick from nobody?
What girl with the flat ass?
I'm just saying, the girl who got to get her ass done, she really don't have to do that. She's going to get the same amount of dick.
If
she
go put legs up to any guy,
he's going to smash her.
Or maybe her self-esteem will go up and you can't fuck at this point.
Right.
No, I've seen Wax fuck some really ugly girls.
Nobody asked nothing about me. Nobody asked nothing about me.
No, but she said self-esteem. I was going to tell a story.
That's the picture?
Which one? That's it right there?
That's whoever posted that is a hater.
they
need to be fucking fired.
No, listen.
Were they fired?
That's like equivalent to your friend like posting a fucked up picture, y'all.
But you know
without
what?
Confirming it with me.
That's only a story because of how she looks now. Yeah. That's it. Like exactly. That's literally because
so that's
what?
An old picture.
That's an old picture.
That's some people's dream body, yo. That's some people's dream body.
You're right. No, for real.
Why did they do that?
Because of how she looks now. And by the way, if she had owned...
That's somebody on her team did that, though.
You think so?
Yo,
that's
guys, what they said, guys. Think about this. They are selling products to people based on a false reality of what they look like.
Yeah, Kylie got the lip kit stuff, but you had your lips done.
And not only have your lip done, you're using Photoshop to manipulate the way you work. So it's false advertising on even the products. Like the whole thing is a charade. It's all fake. So it's like,
but all brands do that. Not just the Kardashians.
I know she got her
Explain, Tammy.
I'm just saying that every brand is Photoshopping everybody. You know, it's not just the Kardashians doing it.
You wait till I come out with my line of gray sweatpants.
You're gonna put some dicks in it.
Big neck pants.
That's right. It's gonna have the print already in it. You know what I'm saying? Men have not cashed in on this the way we need to. You know what I'm saying? We can do the same exact
catfish
thing.
Dick.
Yeah, like that's fucked up.
That's it. Y'all do it all the time with your high waisted jeans and your apple bottom jeans and all that stuff like that. Watch. We're gonna come out with the gray sweatpants with the print already in them.
I definitely need a cock shot now. Then. I'm not
that's
playing
got
with
enough
you.
Dick.
Yo, you know what? Enough. That's true. We
That's
will.
That's gonna be the ad. That's gonna be the ad.
That's not enough dick. Make it enough. Listen, Chloe did this to herself.
Yep.
If she was honest, that old picture wouldn't even faze her. Yep. If she was honest, that old picture would have no impact on her whatsoever. It'd be like, whatever.
Yeah,
if
that's the, she mad at what she used to look like. She didn't like it.
That's
yeah.
it.
But
that's
you don't it. Think those women feel pressure to be beautiful like everybody else?
Who gives a fuck?
They, but they did
you
that.
Why not?
They still get fucked.
We could have loved them for their personality. Listen, it's plenty of reality show stars that ain't sexy that do well. You know what I'm saying?
We watch
that. That's why women probably feel more pressure
than anybody
else.
There's a show about fat people we watch. It's just about fat people. 600-pound life. People watch it.
By the way, I never cared about the Kardashians' beauty. You know what got me about the Kardashians? Their richness.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It was like how white people feel when they watch Good Times, probably. You know what I mean? Like, I was watching the Kardashians, like, damn, they live such a rich life. They don't even realize that's a real world going on. Yeah. Like, they had their own ecosystem. That's what I cared about.
I saw the sex tape.
What?
Let's do some Asking Idiots.
Right. Hoeing healed them. The whole fucking family.
Right. Hoeing definitely healed them.
And by the way, people like to give that sex tape credit. Nah, bro. Plenty of people got sex tapes. They got business talks. They definitely got it right. Somebody in that family got
their
some
mama
business.
Is smart. Chris. Their mama is the beast.
The mama. Yeah. And I think Kim Kardashian too.
She's savvy.
You got to have something smart to get that much.
You got to. You don't just become a billionaire just because of no damn sex tape.
Nah.
All right, let's do some
what you got for us, girl.
Progression. What's you got some good ones, Taylor?
That's Jesus. What could it be?
Asking, that's a good one. I promise this ain't Lucky Says. If you could ask Jesus one question, what would it be?
Jesus.
AJ?
Damn.
Am I living a life that you see fit?
Amen.
Yeah, Amy?
Yeah, that's what I'm gonna ask.
Are you living a life that you see fit?
Am I living the life you want me to live?
Right. What if he tell you I ain't give you that ass for you to get it eaten? Then what you gonna say?
Okay, Jesus, I won't do it no more.
Mm. Really?
I repent.
If Jesus tell me not to get my ass, it's over.
Yeah.
You gotta
stop. He gave us choice.
Hold on. No, hold on. But Jesus you told you not to have Jesus? Sex outside of marriage.
Ooh.
Why you do that?
Also, Jesus told you not to covet thy neighbor's husband or wife, and you've been letting
me. But he ain't say nothing about that bitch around the corner.
And he told y'all to stop eating pork. And he told y'all no shellfish.
Yeah.
So you answer the question then, Schulz.
What?
Answer the question.
What was the question?
That's just why you asked one question.
That's why God let us repent, though.
If Jesus told me to stop eating ass, would I stop?
No. If you could ask Jesus one question, what would it be?
Oh, if I could ask Jesus one question, what would it be?
Yes.
Were you fronting when you were carrying the cross to go get hung on it because you know you're the son of God, so you know you're just going to heaven anyway? Like, were you like faking tears and were you being like, that hurts? Like, but you know it doesn't hurt because you're God. Like, you know what I mean?
And like, but is he God?
He was a man. He's the son of God.
Yeah, but still, he got magical powers. Like, did he ever think about like turning that cross into like a pillow?
Did he have powers or did he just give niggas glasses?
I mean, he turned water into wine. He could walk on water. What else could
he
turn?
He was surfing. We don't know.
He fed a bunch of people.
He's a miracle worker.
He fed a bunch of people with like two loaves of bread and two fish or something like that. What was it?
Yeah.
What was it? Two fish, two bread, green eggs and ham? What was it?
Yeah, red fish, blue fish. It was red fish, blue fish.
Yeah.
And then some green eggs and ham. Yeah.
It was no green eggs.
By the way, Jesus ain't coming back. I want y'all to know that.
Nah,
it's over.
It's other prophets that came and went.
Yeah, Jesus ain't fucking with Earth no more. God ain't even fucking with Earth no more. No.
How you know?
Nah, we got about 100 more years.
There's still a lot of goodness out here.
It is.
That's about right.
It is.
I'm going to be around until about 92.
That's all. And then we out. You know what I mean? I'm telling you, it's only going to get worse from here.
We're going to be old friends.
We need to be optimistic.
Chuck here.
I'm just being realistic.
Hey, baby.
what else we got, Taylor Gang? Where do you guys think you'd be if y'all never met each other? Wow.
Where would Charlamagne and I be if we never met each other? I'd be significantly poorer.
All of us.
I would have less joy.
Aww.
I mean, but I can't say that. Like, I mean, me and Andrew get money together, so Brilliant Idiots has brought a significant amount of income to both of our lives. But I would have I would have less joy because Andrew's more retarded than y'all know. And I'm using that politically incorrect word because there's really no other way to describe it. Him and Duval are absolutely the two most insane. I mean, Wax too, but Wax ain't no comedian. And these motherfuckers be trying shit out on me that I know that I haven't even heard them use on stage yet. But the shit that they be saying is really stupid.
Like, but it makes sense, though.
No, it does. It does. It does. It does make sense. That's it really does make
That's
sense.
That's the problem.
Everybody here on this microphone right now, I'm absolutely positively happy that I met. I feel like we all were
100%.
We all were soul tribe.
Yes.
In another life.
Actual family.
Actual family in another life.
Blood makes you related,
I'm
but
West
family.
West Columbia, what are you?
Huh?
I'm West African. I'm sorry. I said West Columbia.
You from West Columbia?
I'm
Geechee.
I'm Geechee too.
I'm Geechee.
I'm 97% West African.
Yeah, me too.
I'm 100% Geechee.
You ain't Geechee. It's got to be Africa or something, right?
No, it does not have.
I bet you West African. I guarantee you. You did a DNA test yet?
I'm Ogeechee Indian.
No, do that.
If you're around that area,
I'm Ogeechee Indian.
Oh well.
Because even when Ashley and Tammy. When Ashley told me her and Tammy was cool, I was like, that'd make too much sense. You know what I'm saying?
Because
it's just like,
I have a question.
It's all the same energy. It's all the same spirit.
Yeah, it makes sense.
When Tammy was chasing you,
who was this?
Did she seem more of a long distance runner or short distance speed?
It was some long distance speed.
You might be East African, Tammy. It might be something from like Ethiopia, Eritrea, Kenya, something like that.
No, it was definitely long distance speed.
I definitely thought she was going to give up, but listen, she had reinforcements. She could have chilled for a while.
It was like five of us chasing him.
It was five of y'all?
Yeah, it was like me. It was like five of us.
And Ash Charlamagne.
And that's right.
He was chasing you too.
He's running the truck around. I'm trying to catch the fucking truck.
He would like drive up a little bit, Wax would get to the car, and then he'd drive up a little bit more.
Man, those were some good times, man. No, that shit was fun, man.
But why? No.
It was good times.
No, it wasn't fun at the time.
Yes, like, it was.
Gotta go with the fucking road with you, man. And I find how many years later he called her up there. I'm thinking, who's that?
I don't remember that. That part I don't remember. Yeah, I don't remember calling Tammy up there.
I believe Tammy. She ain't a liar.
No, man. Tammy was short. I'm telling you, Tammy was behind the ball.
This dude will fabricate a story.
I believe it so much, and then try to convince you of what you were doing.
Yes!
Like, and she knows when she was working and she wasn't, but he said you were working.
And he called.
Wait, all of y'all met at Benedict?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. All classes.
Interesting. Mm-hmm. I met Ashley when I used to do radio at Hot 98.9 in Charleston. And we had
Z93. Pro-
no, that was Hot 98.9.
Was it?
Yeah.
That long ago?
Yeah, and we did we had a promo called Crush the Haters and the Nas Navigator. And that's when Nas had Hate Me Now out. And we took a navigator to the House of Blues in Myrtle Beach to go watch Nas perform.
Yep.
That's how I met Ashley. And I met Tammy. I was doing a remote somewhere, mm-hmm. and Tammy came to the remote.
It was Big T's barbecue right outside of the barbecue.
Big T's goddamn barbecue.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ, man.
I know.
Time really does fly. I remember both of them situations vividly as a motherfucker.
But you can't remember the thing
Chuck,
about
you remember
the
us. How you met?
I don't know. I know you. I think maybe you might have known so and so first. And then you just
next things we won't care about next
through,
week.
Throw a woman, throw another woman.
Yeah, it was her.
Things we won't care about next week.
It was her. It was her because I remember you telling me that Wax was messing with her. I was like, yeah, Wax in love with her.
This nigga is so crazy.
What?
Things you don't care about next month.
Tomorrow. All right, tomorrow.
Okay, this is the last one. Big MF Mike, do y'all think everyone has a purpose and do you think everyone's purpose has a positive impact?
No. Everybody does have a purpose and everybody's purpose is not always positive.
Mm. At least you'll learn. No.
There's things that happen that could possibly change the world, and that person was supposed to do that. It could mm-hmm. be a negative. Mm-hmm. Somebody,
you think someone's life's purpose is negative? No, I think they don't align with their purpose, and that's why they're doing negative things.
So everybody,
I don't think God puts anybody here to just be
yin and yang. You got to have the positives and the negatives.
I think there was some years God was just trying some shit, man. and he was just making anybody. You know what I'm saying?
But he did a good job with me. I can't read, but I'll be all right the rest of the shit.
I really thought you couldn't read for a long time.
You'll be faking.
I really. Yeah, he had me too. Until social media, I was like, oh, okay, Wax can't read and shit. Like, nigga was messaging back. I wasn't sure.
He texted me back that he read this shit.
Does everybody have a purpose? I think so.
Yeah,
you got
too.
A purpose.
I just but is people- it always positive, though? Everybody's purpose is not always positive.
But at least if you
is
learn
it
off
their
of it.
Their purpose if it's not positive?
Yeah, I don't. Yeah, exactly. I don't think that's your purpose if you purposely doing negative things to people. But then also too, some people don't know they fucked up. You know.
Yeah, it's normal for them.
Yes. I actually will give a little pushback on that. Okay. A serial killer's purpose is to kill as many people as they can, but that's negative.
Predator.
Yeah, but what if they have a just... Well,
it's negative in our world, but just think about the animal kingdom. Humans are just like, you know...
Yeah, we create this morality on top of things.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. So if you take away laws and religion, we just sophisticated animals.
But to that serial killer, that's normal too, though.
Exactly what I'm saying. He's a predator.
But I hear what Tam is saying, which is like, I think it's so easy to get caught up in a negative quote-unquote purpose just because negative shit is so much easier to do. Like, doing drugs is not your purpose, but it can be the driving force of every day of your life. But that's not your purpose. I don't think God put you here to do drugs. You just took the easier way out.
Or be a serial killer. I don't think anybody was put here to be a serial killer.
I don't
killer.
Know,
like, that's
though,
not a purpose.
Because that crackhead who got me to go to college, if he wasn't a crackhead, I probably wouldn't listen to him. They probably made him be a crackhead.
But I don't think that was his purpose. I think he made poor choices. I think destiny's not a matter of chance. It's a matter of choice.
Yeah.
I think people just make poor choices sometimes, and it leads them down a path. But I don't think that's their purpose.
But he had the numbers going to meet a crackhead that day. Because, you know, God got everything lined up, everything is timing. So I was going to meet that person that day. And I feel like a lot of times people say, oh, it's your time. If that's your day to die, that person was aligned to kill you.
To kill you, right. Mm.
So his purpose was to hit your ass up.
You think life is scripted in that way?
No, I don't think it is.
No,
it's impossible, either. Right?
We are, everybody in this room, we are all our own judges and executioners. If I feel like I want you up out of here right now, I could do something.
You can do something. You can fart. I can get the fuck out of here.
I can get you up out of here. The judicial system.
Yeah, bless.
Yeah.
That's the Bible.
He hit me.
That's
anything.
God.
I had a convo that I think I'll put out in a couple of weeks with the ayahuasca shaman.
Ooh.
You know the drug ayahuasca?
I can't wait to do it.
The medicine. He would refer to it as a medicine. And what he did is he spoke about it. He said ayahuasca brings you to your purpose. And
I keep hearing it.
I think a lot of people... end up doing the drug because they're in a kind of desperate place in their lives where they are trying to seek that and trying to find that. And who knows, maybe this experience does bring you closer. Maybe it doesn't. I'm not necessarily advocating for it, but that's what he was saying. Like, not only did it help him find his purpose, a lot of other people, it helped them find their purpose. And he kind of defined purpose as the thing that you want to do every single day. And you're not trying to do it. I'm going to butcher this. But the thing that you want to do every single day, and you are grateful that you have the opportunity to do it.
Okay. Well, with that said, I know people who have done ayahuasca, whatever the shit is, probably you pronounce it, and they don't want to do nothing. Like they literally, their existence is just like vibing every day. They're not bums by any means.
Yeah, yeah.
But they're not working. They don't, you know what I mean? Yeah, like they're just living. Now, mind you, they were rich before.
Yeah.
Right.
They just unplugged from the matrix.
Exactly. And they were.
I want to be that.
Yes. They
I
were.
Unplugged. That's
their purpose, literally, is going around finding more of what the meaning to life is. Because they said they saw something when they was on the ayahuasca that showed them life in a different way. So now they actually just live, which is a beautiful way to live. I would love to live that way on an island.
I mean, look at Duval, right? Like, Duval is straddling both worlds. Like, Duval will go on tour, he'll go perform, he'll go work. Right. The essence of rich broke is I'm broke, so I got to keep on working. But I'm also rich because I make a lot of money when I work. But when he's not working, he's on an island just chilling and enjoying nature, enjoying the stars, enjoying the water. He doesn't need much to keep him happy. What?
Ed Sheeran lived that same life.
There you go.
It's freedom. Rich is freedom.
That's right. Ed Sheeran will drop an album and he'll tour all year long and then disappear for 2-3 years.
There you go.
That's what he's doing now. Like, and just be living his life. which I think is a great existence.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Great existence.
Mm-hmm. Balance.
All right, is that all, guys and gals?
A lot of people don't have that luxury to just disappear for.
That's true.
That's true.
I did a candy bar. It was like a psychedelic something.
It was
like
had shrooms in it. Yeah. Shrooms. Yeah. Hey, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
And the first thing I thought was, are people like billionaires, are they more like religious than just regular people? I mean, are regular people more religious?
Of course.
Are closer to God than people with a lot of money?
Of course.
Because the money then becomes the God. You know what I'm saying? So like you, people with less resources tend to be more
reliable.
More religious. They are more like more Christian.
They rely on God.
Exactly.
The worst.
That's the first thought I had.
The worse your life is, the more you value what's after life.
I don't know, bro.
I need my paradise now.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, I'm not waiting to die to get there.
I'm always searching for like the higher meaning of things. Like I want to know the real purpose. Like I believe in God.
Just chill and exist and be present. That's what I'm into.
I'm always still want to be.
Doesn't the Bible say something like the rich man will enter heaven when the camel passes through the needle, the eye of a needle or something like that?
Yeah.
Yeah, because you got to give away your earthly possessions, right? You couldn't be storing that wealth. You should be sharing it with one another.
That's going to happen anyway.
Yeah, like, it is. Whether you like it or not, your shit ain't going to come with you to the afterlife.
No. Yeah. Now, I'm going to tell you something. What if, though? What if that's some bullshit?
We don't know.
What if you give away all your money and then you get somewhere else?
Get there and it's a Wells Fargo.
And you're like, who the hell told you to give all your shit away?
Well, the Egyptians like, tried that.
We
and
take debit
here.
Credit. It cost $10 million to get in here.
I'm just saying. What is
it? You gave all your shit up.
I'm just saying.
All these whales is fucked up. They want their money back.
It's amazing how we know so much about a place none of us have ever been.
Now you're going to be a gin pop with the regular
people. Exactly. You dumbass.
You got to start all over. You got to build that wealth all over again.
Somebody balling out with your money. And then what if they give you peaks into the life you used to live?
Wow. See what people do with your money.
You done gave away all your money.
Damn.
You know what I'm saying? Some woman you done gave your money to out here just popping that pussy to some other dude.
Oh, God damn.
Probably smashing your boy. Damn.
Damn.
Some diddy shit.
Did y'all see that movie Soul?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah,
I did.
Yeah,
I love good,
it. I did.
Man.
It was good. Yeah. It was good. It was good. All right. Make sure y'all listen to the We Talk Back podcast on the Black Effect iHeartRadio podcast network with AJ and Tam Bam.
That's right.
Okay. The Carolina Zone, South Carolina Zone.
Yeah.
And make sure you listen to Bully and the Beast with Wax and L'Oreal.
Yeah.
Yep.
And make sure you listen to Flagrant 2 with Andrew and Akash and Mark Gagging On.
And Alex Media.
And Alex Media. Do what? Tammy, what?
Oh, if y'all want to hear the true story of what happened with Wax.
What story with Wax?
Y'all tune into our next episode.
Let's go!
Tell me what's the story.
Now that's
story
how we create content, baby.
Yeah, tune in.
Content right
tune
there.
Tune in, what's baby.
I dedicate a whole episode to your ass,
dog. Yeah, we're going to clear the air.
Now leave it right there. Leave it right there. Leave it right there. Leave it right there. Leave it right
there. As always, if you listen to this podcast, you think we're smart, you think we're intelligent, you think we're brilliant, you're absolutely right. But if you listen to the podcast and you think we're just a couple idiots who don't know shit, you're right too. It's the Brilliant Idiots Podcast. And the Brilliant Idiots Podcast is recorded at WTF Media, okay? A sort of black-owned studio, okay? Sort of. Weezy's half black. Alex is half black, so together they make one black person. All right?
Sitting on the couch for 13 months. All I keep thinking about is getting fucked up. Whippets. Wanna take all my sweats and clip my pubes. Hey, where's my picker? Tired of getting caught jerking off on Zoom.
Tubing, what are you doing, sir?
Fauci says I need to double up my mass. Well, tell the little gerbil he can kiss my ass.
I think it's time.
Open her up like a can of beans. Open her up like a jar of weed. Open her up like Forrest Whitaker's eye. Open her up and let's see what's inside. Like a good old boy with a sharp knife skin and a bug.